Well, this is it. The biggest night of the year. The moment we've all been waiting for. Our contestants have just arrived here at the Sky City Grand Hotel in Auckland, where very soon all four houses go under the hammer in our live auction. Our teams get to keep every dollar they make at auction above the reserve price, and the team that makes the most money gets an additional grand prize of $80,000. Yes, this is it, folks. Welcome to the grand finale of the Block NZ.
It has taken 12 grueling weeks for our teams to transform the remains of two pre-war bungalows into stylish contemporary family homes. It all began with an incomplete set of plans.
Where do you start?
I don't really know what I'm looking at.
Our teams invested every ounce of energy.
Tired.
Damo looks like he's fallen off the back of a bus, been hit by another bus, and is just wandering home.
Infused a little flair.
For the first time in block history, a perfect 10.
I am not surprised that the editor of a magazine gave them a 10.
And threw in all of the passion they could muster.
I'm gutted.
I mean, how do you win if what you feel you've done is better than what the winners have done?
You're right, honey.
There was drama in spades.
Welcome to the block, everyone.
What?
I'm speechless.
Our whole house and garage is completely flooded.
There's no way to stop water coming in without a roof.
For the first time in block history, we're going to be forced to move the room completion deadline.
What?
If we don't get Jib next week, it's on your head.
Get the guys out now!
I don't think anyone has ever been this unfinished before in the history of the block.
It just feels like big fat failure.
And this season saw some of the fiercest competition yet.
Yes! We got past them! Come on, Benny!
Go! No!
But they weathered the storm.
This has been an incredible journey.
I'm real proud of you.
I don't think that we will ever experience anything like this again.
And it all comes down to tonight. It's the grand finale. We'll see the thousands who swarm to the biggest Block NZ open homes in the show's history.
Welcome to the block, everyone!
Probably one of the coolest experiences I've ever had.
The crucial auction order is decided, and the four houses go under the hammer live.
Sold here.
And we crown the champions of the Block NZ 2014.
After 12 weeks of hard labour, renovating, building, painting and plastering, I think you'd all agree, guys, this is the most important night of all, isn't it?
Yeah.
Joe, is that apprehension or excitement?
I'm excited. I'm a little bit nervous. Like, obviously, it's been a long 12 weeks and this is really the night that, yeah, we've all been waiting for, so it's quite scary.
Damo, we never really see much out of you.
No.
Will the poker face be broken if you happen to win this thing?
Oh, yeah, I'd be chucking a few beers down my throat, eh? Yep.
Marie and James, you've been wonderful to follow along, haven't you? James, how did you control her? Because this is one of the most competitive ladies I've ever met.
Controller? I don't think there is any controller. She's just all to herself and I just along for the ride, I think.
Once again, you're a little bit like Damo. We don't get much out of you, so how are you feeling?
Yeah, the nerves have been building over the last few days, but we're finally here, and it's coming to the end, so.
Alex and Corbin, yes. Do you like it when a plan comes together?
Oh, I love it when a plan comes together.
Yeah, yeah. We're definitely serial planners, so, yeah. You know, it's been good to see a few of them come off.
It's been a project, hasn't it? But you're nearly there.
Yeah, it has been a huge 12 weeks, and, you know, everyone's had their ups and downs. Mm.
It's been cool to share it with everyone, though.
Yeah, it's good to see it coming to an end, and it'll be good. It'll be good to see what happens tonight.
And Quinn and Ben, it's been a tough road to hoe. How are you feeling?
Yeah, it's been really hard. It's been hard for everyone, but I think it's totally worth it. It's been pretty amazing.
Yeah, like all the hard work's done now, and like all we can really do is just try not to get too nervous, sit back, hope the houses all sell well, and if we win, pants might be coming off again. It'll be live, so you won't be able to blur it this time.
Well, all I can say at this point, guys, is welcome and the best of luck.
Thank you.
Well, sitting just a stone's throw away in the idyllic central city suburb of Point Chevalier are four fantastic houses, undoubtedly the finest we've ever seen on the Block NZ. And tonight, live, they all go under the hammer. It may be quiet now, but it was a very different story just a few days ago, when thousands of people turned out to have a look at this year's stunning Block NZ houses, when they were open to the public for the very first time.
As the sun came up in Point Chevalier, the preparation for the open homes began in earnest. And the teams ducked out for some key items.
There's the flower.
To make that all-important first impression.
Yep, grab those, that'd be good.
Back at the block, the fans queued. And queued.
Pretty ones.
I'm thinking vases.
Okay, there you go.
We've been in line since about 6:40.
Waiting for the opportunity to meet the teams.
Look how many there are.
And get a glimpse of their houses.
Like that.
You gotta take the stickers off though.
What?
Just setting the table, honey. We've got people coming for lunch. We've got 7,000 of them.
Pretty cool contestants.
Yeah. Right, hailing from South Auckland, Marianne James. Yeah.
There was this huge roar. It was so cool.
I can't believe this many people have come out this early in the morning to see us.
And representing Auckland, Alex and Corbin. Yeah.
I cannot believe how many people want to come and see the houses. It was really cool. But probably one of the coolest experiences I've ever had.
All the way from Canterbury, welcome Quinn and Ben.
All these people were screaming for us. It was insane and so surreal. And I got goosebumps and my eyes were watering a little bit.
And last but not least, from Manawatu, make some noise for Joe and Damo.
Like rock stars, lots of Joe and Damo, like screaming, people so excited. It's awesome.
It gives us great pleasure to announce the block for 2014 officially open. After the break, the homes are open and the fans get their first peek.
What did you think?
Awesome.
It just feels like a real family home.
And we look back at our team's journey on the Block NZ 2014.
You kind of look like Bono from U2.
Yep. I think it's Bono.
Oh, Bono.
La 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 la.
Welcome back to the Sky City Grand Hotel, where later tonight, four superb Point Chef houses go under the hammer in our live auction. Now, Quinn and Ben, this is a big night. Quinn, I hope you've got a lot of support come up from Christchurch.
Yeah, some of our family have come up to support us, but just everyone back home have been so supportive and just backing us all the way, and it's such a nice feeling, eh?
Yeah, it's good. Dad's here, Quinn's mum's here. Yeah, it's great. And her sister as well. Mm-hmm.
You've worked so hard for 12 weeks. You haven't had much success along the way. How are those itchy hands of yours, though, Ben, right now?
The itchy hands are actually a wee bit sweaty at the moment, right? But they're still a wee bit itchy, so it must be a good sign.
That's good.
Tell us about the belief you have in your house.
Look, we just made this house for, like, a nice family. We want to make sure that it's fenced off for dogs and kids and stuff, so it's nice and safe. Mm-hmm. It's really private back there, and, yeah, I hope someone's going to enjoy it as much as we hope they do. Yeah.
All the best. Marie and James, you started off with a hiss and a roar, didn't you? Winning all the room reveals and everything, and then all of a sudden it just petered off, but you stuck true to your plan, and you must be so proud, James, of that cool Pacifica paradise that you've created.
Yeah, we're really proud of what we've achieved, and it's been a pretty amazing journey along the way too, and all the supporters, I think, all our family and friends kind of pulled us through.
We just had a really good team that kept us strong the whole way through and made sure we were focused right from the start to end, so we couldn't have done it without any of them.
Marie, you're a competitor. Have you almost viewed this as a game of sorts to compete in?
Yeah, I'm a competitor, but I'm more a competitor with myself. I'm always constantly trying to push myself to be better than the time before, and I've proven so much to myself, and I guess both me and James have just shown each other what we can do, so...
Yeah. James, were you surprised at just how hard she went at things along the way?
Yeah, I knew she was pretty competitive, but I wasn't expecting some of those screams and the jumping and the clapping that we got along the way. It was pretty entertaining from my point of view.
Good luck to you too.
Thanks, Mark.
All right, let's head back to the open homes now and take a peek inside with the fans as we have a look back at our couple's journey while on the Block NZ. Starting with you two, Quinn and Ben.
Cool.
Nice.
So many people come to see us, and it's really exciting.
Hey, how's
you like it?
Yeah. I love Quinn and Ben because they are good.
What did you think?
Awesome. So
really?
Great. Yeah.
Cool house.
Thank you. Yeah. It's been quite a roller coaster, I guess, for us, and despite everything, we're so, so proud of our house. I think it's beautiful.
We've been waiting here for hours.
All this hard work, we're finally going to find out what's going to happen after it all.
We've already got some good interest here in the house, so it's really exciting.
They like what they see.
For Christchurch duo Quinn and Ben, it was love at first sight.
Okay. Yeah.
But not when it came to house one.
There is no real view from what I can see.
They had a change of heart upstairs.
Is that where we were standing the other day?
Yeah, it must have been. It's pretty high, eh? I'm starting to feel pretty good about our wee house.
She wasn't feeling so great getting around it.
You all right?
And we soon found out why.
We're pregnant! Oh my God! Any quicker than a baby!
They got a Block baby!
Down but not out.
The hardest part for me has been the mornings and the tiredness.
Our renovation rookies ground it out. With their undeniable affection for one another.
Ben, where's the pence in the relationship? I think. Oh no. You kind of look like Bono from U2.
I think it's Bono.
Oh, Bono. I honestly think we've got one leg in each trouser leg.
Quinn took charge of the first room challenge, gambling on carpet in the garage.
Are you sure that it's not a big waste of money since we've already polished the floor?
Well, it's going to win us the room, 100%.
Okay, hope we win.
Alex and Corbin. The budget blowout forced tradie cuts and Ben to pull overtime. Day.
You don't mind staying up?
I don't mind.
You're sick of me anyway.
After day.
We're miles behind.
After day. And the pressure was mounting.
I'm really worried that I'm not going to get all of this done.
He released it the only way he knows how.
Oh, don't.
So how are you feeling with the baby and all?
Quinn and Ben, 5.5 from Mark, 12.5, but disappointing.
Week.
Last again.
After week.
More disappointment.
Same old story.
It's just called the mixture.
It didn't seem to matter what they tried. No one was buying it. The sentiment only soured when it came to marking Marie and James's Dinner Wars effort.
Cheers, guys. Cheers to Dinner Wars. Yeah. And may the best team win.
Yeah. Quinn and Ben scored your fun and your food particularly low.
Wow.
We feel like we had been stabbed in the back.
Mother.
So that's how it is.
But the sour taste didn't last long, and Quinn and Ben went back to doing what they did best, entertaining us.
Shall we see what goes with our tiles?
So ugly. As long as we get it all sealed up before the rain comes, because it's looking ominous. Yeah.
Does that word mean?
I don't know, I just heard people say it.
8 times brighter than what?
What?
A potato.
What?
And their sense of humour definitely won over the fans.
Look up and bend this. Bend it on the fence. Nice.
Despite not winning a single room on the block, they still have high hopes they can go all the way.
It's just going to change our life if we win this. We've only been married like 2 years and it would just set us up for life.
Yeah, our house at the moment probably isn't fit to look after a baby. But, you know, 80 grand, we could do a lot of things to that little house.
Next door, the fans are lined up at Marie and James's house.
Oh, my God!
It's crazy outside. It's pretty exciting. We're going to finally meet the fans of the block and everyone who's been supporting us.
You're my favourite.
But there was one special fan Marie was eager to impress.
So, what do you think, Dad?
Oh, it's quite cool. I like the mirror.
Yeah.
These cupboards?
Yeah, those are cupboards.
What's that, Maltika?
Yeah, that's Maltika bliss shiitake that we chose to do it. Peter Hay have been really smart about the way they use the storage in the kitchen. Mm. It's everywhere, like here, all the way around.
No, I'm very, very proud of you, Marie.
Oh, thanks, Dad. I can tell by your smile.
What are you thinking?
Awesome.
Awesome?
Really good.
Pretty good.
Really
good.
I love the front door. The front door's awesome. I want to touch it.
So you're more impressed this year than maybe last year?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think the work's just way up there. Last year was still good, but it's just like, wow.
Feedback's been sensational.
Yeah.
Like you and I, they all love the open space and feel and light brightness. They just feel that, you know, I think it's going to really appeal to a family.
Yeah, you just can't control it now. It's all out of our hands pretty much, and just got to wait and see.
You're on the block, NZ.
From the moment the dream came true.
Is this for real?
This is for real.
The ambition grew.
We're just going to bring everything. Team James and Marie, high five.
Moving into Streetside House 2.
Let's go and check out this view.
We were meeting one of the Block NZ's fiercest competitors, Marie.
We've got a lot more space than our next door neighbours at the front.
But at least their neighbours were dry.
James and Marie's tarpaulin is flapping away. And buckets of water are coming down.
Whoa!
Last to get their roof on meant keeping the water out early on was an impossible task.
Seal's going on tomorrow.
And when James didn't communicate his intentions to remove the tarps, it rained tears.
Our room is flooded. Do you care so much about this house? It is quite upsetting.
Breaking point came on garage reveal day. and they finished in last place on the scoreboard.
Asking your body to just keep pushing and pushing, you've got very limited energy, and it's emotionally draining. But it's just what you gotta do. Like, we're so competitive and we're such fighters to the end.
All I know for sure, James, is we are not coming last again.
Our fire and ice couple made a dramatic comeback.
Okay.
From despair to dynamic duo in 1 week.
I really like the feel of the ring.
So do I.
From last to first, Marie and James.
Holy moly.
They had a secret weapon in Builder Martin.
This vanity looks amazing.
He inspired James.
Well done.
Go! And the winning feeling rolled on.
We won, we won, we won, we won.
It's a boat.
Back in the winner's circle again, Marie and James. They've created a modern Pacific theme with natural elements.
Gosh, this is so cool.
Pops of colour and technology at every turn.
Just tap the tuner button, straight away listen to radio.
Oh, no way! Oh my gosh!
They've wrapped a strong team around them.
What are you doing?
Oh, you're gonna love that.
And answered every demand that's been thrown at them.
Oh, it's yum.
This has been an incredible journey. So many highs and then a few lows, but we've both proved to each other what it is that we can do. And I think we've both exceeded our expectations.
Are we having a baby?
No.
But one expectation hasn't been met.
I need to get a ring first, James.
Hmm? I'm pretty used to getting asked when I'm going to put a ring on it. I've been getting it from our family for like years and years, and our friends for years, and now get it from the Blockaholics as well.
You do get to a point, you're like, maybe he's never gonna do it. And I joke to him about I will do it if he doesn't do it. So, yeah, I'll ask you if you don't ask me.
Maybe. I'll say no if you do it.
Up next, more verdicts from our open home visitors.
Joe and Dave, this was awesome. Views are colour.
And we're not far away from our first auction. Welcome back to the Block NZ Grand Finale, the night we've all been waiting for, where later on all four houses go under the hammer in our much-anticipated live auction. Now, Alex and Corbin, it's fair to say you guys push the block to territory it's never been before with your highly ambitious plan, which nearly backfired on you, didn't it?
Yeah, well, we always thought it's better to try and fail than to not try at all. And we definitely push it to the limit. But, you know, we're so happy with what we did and we wouldn't change anything.
Mm. We always knew we were going to be a bit overambitious, but we just worked as hard as we possibly could. And in the end, we did get to finish the house.
This is a little question for you. If it had been your own house that you were doing up for yourself, would you have pushed so hard?
Oh, we would have pushed even further if it was our own house, for sure. Yeah, we always kind of dream big. We're pretty ambitious people, so, yeah.
I don't think that's humanly possible.
Well, we wouldn't have set ourselves 3 months to finish a house.
Now, Joe and Damo, you had a rather roller coaster ride, you could say, on the block. Damo, you were getting a little bit frustrated, weren't you, early on, because you weren't winning anything, but then all of a sudden you started to win. Second half was an absolute beauty, wasn't it?
Yeah, we sort of picked up the ball at the end and sort of ran with it, and we did really well, so really happy.
Game isn't over yet, though, is it?
Not yet, no.
No, not yet. No, it was great coming second, but when we started getting some firsts, that was an awesome feeling. So, yeah, we were very happy.
And, Joe, you just kept that smile going. You worked hard.
Yep.
Right up until the wind up my wife scenario when we saw you crack a little, didn't we?
A little bit, yeah. I just think that we were just, you know, really tired by that point, and it was a great prank, possibly not the best timing.
Bad but timing. Bad prank.
I'm all good. I'm fine.
Damo, do you reckon you did any sleep building along the way?
Yeah, we did a bit of sleep building.
building in the middle of your sleep, really, because let's face it. You were stuffed by about halfway through.
Yeah, it was mentally hard. It was physically hard, but then it got mentally hard, which was the hardest part of all. There were some long nights there that you didn't think the 12 weeks would ever finish, but we got here and we're finally here, so it's an awesome feeling.
OK, Alex and Corbin, let's head back to your house now and the droves of fans who turned out in Point Chef. And after that, we'll have a look back at John Damo's game of two halves while on the block NZ.
Yeah, that was actually the highlight of the day for me.
So let's have a look at the Trade Me app and see how it looks on screen.
Oh, it looks really great, eh?
Yeah.
Those photos are just amazing.
Have you seen how many people are watching?
Yes. No. So let's see how many views it's had. It's like 8,000.
It's had so many views already.
Do you think we've got a winner?
Oh, we think we've got a winner. Oh,
Walking in today, I felt this like immense sense of pride for what we've put together.
Do you like it?
It's amazing.
Can I take a photo of
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Cool.
Thank you. Do you know one of the other kids hit me on the head with this hammer?
Walls.
I couldn't foresee us creating any more than what we've created, and I think we can go home completely satisfied with what we've achieved on the block.
Yeah.
Alex and Corbin marched in, determined, and with more renovation miles than the other teams.
I really like these growing
vines,
up there.
Yeah.
Corbin had built a shipping container house before, and they'd have to draw on every ounce of his experience with House 3.
Wow.
Obviously, the first floor hasn't been built yet.
Last to get their roof, they faced setback after setback.
Oh, my God! That's inside. This week was really hard, mainly because of the weather.
Playing catch-up, they regrouped. Soon showcased Corbin's engineering skills.
Yay! Who has that in their garage?
And fashioned by Alex's design smarts.
Hey, somebody that's actually got some styling going on their garage.
Alex and Corbin.
Oh my God.
If you were to create an analogy for the way Alex and I work on the block, it would be we're baking a cake. And at the start of the week, we formulate the recipe. I bake the cake and Alex ices it and makes it look pretty. And
That's a good analogy.
It actually works really, really well.
Yeah.
Wild ambition.
So we're actually going to have the bench seat cantilever over.
You can't buy it, so I thought we'll make it, you know?
Was starting to push them to the edge.
That's all I can do. This is all I can do.
The painting fairy's here.
You look gorgeous.
Awesome.
It's lovely to be doing it with you.
This just drives me crazy.
Oh, well, get used to it.
But they got it together.
I love the colour palette. It's really warm. It's probably more feminine than masculine.
In the most perfect way.
For the first time in block history, for an inside room, a perfect 10. Alex and Corbin.
The point is to produce an incredible house, and that's what our goal is.
But it all unravelled in living room week.
I didn't sleep all last night. I've been so stressed out about finishing.
Unwilling to compromise their grand design.
We're not going to meet the room reveal, and I'm really sad about it.
It's ridiculous. What a stupid week.
One of the negatives to being a perfectionist is that when you don't get things perfect, it actually really weighs on your mind and you think about it a lot.
I see confidence bordering on arrogance.
They went from heroes to zeros.
Looks a bit empty, doesn't it?
It does.
But a flabbergasting effort over the past 3 weeks has seen them complete a house at the cutting edge of design and sustainable living. And they tied with Joe and Damo with 5-room wins, the most on the block this season.
I'm really, really proud of what Alex and I have put together.
The result of the auction, whatever it may be, If we do well with it, it's going to allow us to get closer to starting a family, probably. That's probably the most important thing.
Oh, well done. I'm really proud of you.
Down the drive at house number 4, the superheroes have turned up for Joe and Damo.
Joe and Damo, go hard, mate.
Super Damo!
There's a few superheroes that have turned up. People have worn their undies on the outside of their clothes today in support of superheroes.
We love Joe and Damo!
So happy!
Cool, that's awesome, hey?
I wanted to bring you guys into this room because I think that this is the really big selling feature of the house.
Our real estate agents have been really positive.
Really hope the fans love our house too.
It's just a special, special place.
Just love personalities as it's come through, but it feels very real, but it's really well thought out. It's beautiful.
Good job, guys. It looks amazing.
Thank you so much.
Awesome house, guys.
Thank you.
Honestly, our favourite.
Joe and Damo's was awesome. It's the best. The views are colour.
The view here and the styling. And it just feels like a real family home.
It's really nice. Today's been just an amazingly cool experience and we're going to look back on it for the rest of our lives.
It's awesome.
Hi, I'm Joe and I'm 34.
And I'm Damo and I'm 36 and we live in Fielding.
They arrived in the Big Smoke, newlyweds.
So we're not going on a honeymoon at the moment.
Probably a horror moon, which will last 10 weeks.
What eventuated was a dream start.
John Damo.
Wow.
Winning the crucial Dulux Colour Challenge.
You have won first choice of where you guys want to live. Of course, you get to decide where all these other guys live as well.
Oh, my gosh.
It was love at first sight down the back right corner of the block.
Check this out for a view.
Oh my god, that is an amazing view.
You've chosen house 4.
Yeah.
Awesome. Ta-da. I just changed my mind.
They set about creating a timber-themed, nature-inspired, family-friendly home. Mounting a cape crusade, firstly on the garage build.
Oh no, obviously you still haven't put out your wedge.
Where Joe let Damo off the leash.
Doing the old sprinkler in there, and the fire's coming off. Sold.
It was a man cave, missing that magic spark, signalling in what would become an all too familiar story. Alex and Corbin, Marie and James,
back in the winner's circle. Alex and Corbin,
second again.
Yeah.
Gut wrenching.
It's getting mentally hard now.
I suppose you. What is your name?
It's Johnston.
Joe bounced
back.
That's
a funny name for a hippo.
Shopping!
Doing what Joe does best.
Aren't they cool? They're crates.
She's got a really good eye for design and colour and all that stuff, so.
But while she shopped up a storm,
water coming.
Damo was creating all sorts of hazards at home.
Are you melting the pipe?
No.
Did I just say to you, don't melt the pipe?
Your fire starter. Did you burn this bucket or what?
Oh, I melted my pants.
I said I could smell it burning.
These are my good pants.
Of course, burning wasn't the only method of destruction.
What did you just break?
Oh, I don't know.
It's like a bull in a china shop, aren't you?
These things here.
Don't break any of the furniture.
Human wrecking ball, Jean-Claude Van Damo could rip.
It's not a nice fruit salad.
Please grab it.
Tear and bust his way through anything. He even came under friendly fire.
Oh. You think that's funny or something, do you?
I think this has a very strong buyer's appeal.
Absolutely.
But when it came to the most important room in the house, they nailed it.
So the winner, for the first time this season, Joe and Damo.
And the winning didn't stop there.
It's an $8,000 bonanza for Joe and Damo.
Once they got outdoors, they took out both spaces, finishing with an impressive 5 wins, tied with Alex and Corbin. Once again, it's Joe and Damo. Yay.
So happy that we have created a beautiful home that someone or family is just going to absolutely fall in love with.
If we win the block, we're going to go on our honeymoon.
Been on the horror moon for 3 months. It'll be time to do a honeymoon, so that'll be really cool.
Coming up, we find out who you voted the winners of the People's Choice Award. And the final challenge results, which will determine tonight's crucial auction order.
Sold here.
Our bidders have arrived. Of course, the team's agents are preparing for the biggest night of the year. There is plenty of excitement. And of course, our teams, well, they're starting to look pretty nervous.
They certainly are, Shannon. But before we get down to the serious business of the auction, I think we should take the time now to just put a smile on one of our team's dials, shall we?
Why not?
Because over the last 8 weeks, our People's Choice Award has seen you at home voting for your favourite team. And speaking of that support, Joe and Damo, Damo, you have worked yourself to exhaustion. Have you sensed that just the support at home that is behind you, though?
Yeah, it's been amazing, especially coming from a small town like Fielding. Everybody's behind us in the Manawatū region. It's been massive, but not just them. It's just been all over the country. It's been amazing, so... yeah, it's been amazing, eh?
Yeah, the support has honestly been just awesome. Like, when we're having real tough times on the block, just we just know that everyone's been backing us and it's just really got us through some tough times. So it's been good.
Now, Alex and Corbin, when I called you out at the open homes and you were able to see your fans, your screaming fans, for the very first time, how did that make you feel?
It was so cool. It was quite overwhelming. We didn't actually know we had that many supporters, and the first team that I saw was a whole bunch of girls dressed like me, and I was like, what? Someone likes me! But yeah, it was really cool. We definitely felt that support, eh?
Corbin, how have you felt about being labelled a Superman?
I don't know about that, Mark. It's been pretty challenging, and there's been a lot of support, and we just really, really appreciate it.
Quinn and Ben, I sense that you worried about vilifying yourselves with the population because you voted strategically in dinner wars, but then the next morning, over the fence, pops a banner with support.
Yeah, we were having a bit of a crappy time, and then we woke up one morning, came down, and the next door neighbours had flopped a banner over the fence, and it said, Quinn and Ben, you're awesome, be encouraged, and it just made us feel so good, and... Yeah, it was so nice, eh?
The same lady actually cooked us a fruitcake the next day as well. And I had a couple of slices and then accidentally left it out in the rain, so sorry about that.
I hope you gave her a score of more than 3 for it.
Yeah, it was definitely a good 5.5.
Now, Marie and James, people have loved you and we saw so much support at the open homes, people that were really behind you. But you guys created another fan favourite, didn't you, and Martin?
Yeah, Martin is awesome. We were so lucky to have him and he seriously has his own following. It could probably compete against all of our followings.
The winner of the Block NZ People's Choice competition and a brand new Honda CR-V Sport is... Joe and Damo!
Well done, buddy.
You're forgetting something, like the trophy. Oh, geez, congratulations, awesome. Damo.
Thanks very much. Cool.
And Joe, I'll give you the keys,
oh,
okay?
Yay. Well, there you have it, Joe and Damo, winners of the Block NZ's People's Choice Competition and driving home in a brand new Honda CR-V Sport. Make sure you stick around because after the break, the time has come to reveal that very crucial auction order.
Coming up, the final challenge results are in and we reveal the all-important house auction order. Na, 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 na.
Earlier this week, the teams took part in a triathlon of challenges, testing their creativity, their athleticism, and their knowledge of the block 2014. The winner of each challenge received 3 points. 2 points for second place, and third received 1 point. If you came last in the challenge, no points at all. Here's a reminder of just how those challenges panned out. Welcome, everyone.
Hi.
The first challenge was the Nosy Neighbours quiz, where Joe and Damo and Quinn and Ben proved they knew the most.
I feel bad holding this up, but I think maybe she might have said on the schnoz.
Big. Oh.
Sorry, bro.
When it comes to the other teams.
I'm going to say big nose, big what? Big feet. Good on them. Now the whole country knows.
They knows.
Yeah.
But a series two tiebreaker question.
So I want you to give me, to the nearest dollar, the amount of money that Alice and Caleb walked away with last year. Joe and Damo were the closest by 1,000.
Saw Joe and Damo take out the coveted 3 points for the first challenge.
Well done, Joiness.
The next challenge was a test of brawn.
Set, go! I find myself next to Damo, and he's going like this. Ah! Ah!
And brains.
This one needs to get up there.
Which saw Marie and James climb their way back up the leaderboard.
We hear this blood-curdling scream as if someone's getting killed. Yes! Oh, I'm sorry.
Followed closely by Quinn and Ben.
Yes. We realise we pick up 2 more points.
Then, by my calculations, that means that we're coming first.
The final leg of this block triathlon saw the teams partner up with a local celebrity.
Hi, Joe.
It's not really the person I'm really looking forward to seeing, to be honest.
And produce a viral video to market their houses. All the teams dressed to impress.
So James, get cheeky.
But one was willing to bear it all.
Let's get naked. Why not?
In the hope of taking out at least one honest block win before they leave.
Other than dinner wars, we haven't won any challenges, so it would be an awesome way to just top off the block to choose our own destiny.
Right, you guys completed the first two parts of the auction order decider challenge back at the block.
And we have the final scores right now hidden behind this board.
But as you can see, leading the race after the first challenge, which was the block quiz challenge, was Joe and Damo. And it's a nice one to win, isn't it, Joe? Because it shows that you have some interest in your competitors.
Yeah, it was actually a really fun challenge because we actually found out quite a lot about each other that we didn't know. So it was really good.
Or does it just mean, Damo, that you're a good listener?
It just means we love them all, eh? So just...
How nice. OK, so we move then on to the great tradition of the midwinter block swim, and it doesn't really surprise me that charging out of the water and completing the puzzle was Marie and James, because Marie, the minute the gun went off and you entered that water, it was all on, wasn't it?
It was just so cold. I just wanted to make sure it was in and out as quick as possible.
And James, how about that blood-curdling scream when she finished it?
Oh, tell me about it. I think she gave everyone a fright, including herself.
Yep.
OK, but right up the top there, on 4 points, is Quinn and Ben. Now, you guys are yet to win a challenge. This would be a big one to win, wouldn't it?
Yeah, definitely. It would be something a bit different if we won something on the block this year, wouldn't it?
Why not leave it to the last night?
Yeah.
Well, we've got no idea what order we'd want to go in, but if anyone's going to choose, it would be cool if it would be us.
Well, I'll tell you who can't choose. Alex and Corbin, who won everything along the way, but because of your very poor performance in these first two challenges, you have no chance here, do you? Does that concern you in any way?
No, it doesn't really concern us. The auction's going to be a bit of a lottery, so, yeah.
We feel we've done all we can do now, and it's up to the buyers.
Right. The final viral video challenge was left up to you, the viewer, to decide. Shannon, do you want to do the honours for us?
Well, we have tallied those final scores. The winner
of the Auction Order Decider Challenge and the team that gets first dibs on Auction Order here tonight is Marie and James.
It's Madden!
Who would have thought a topless Scotsman in a kilt? But that's such a good job.
The ladies love Madden.
So that's great news. I've got some even better news for you right now. I want that auction order now.
Oh, goodness.
No pressure.
Oh, my gosh. Now?
Look, I know it's a big decision, guys, and I don't want to rush you, but I am going to rush you because we haven't got all night. So what's it going to be?
Yeah, it's pretty huge. We've had to talk to the Bailey's guys and the open homes and things like that. And, we think we want to go second. Put Alex and Corbin first.
OK.
And then Quinn and Ben in third, and then Joe and Damo in fourth.
Yeah, we just wanted to do what we felt was best for everyone, and based on the advice we were given, we feel that's the right thing to do.
We're all happy with that?
Yeah.
Good.
Start breathing again.
Well done. That was tense, wasn't it?
Yeah. It's just we're holding everyone's futures in our hands. That's how we feel right now.
Well, you should feel that way. And just like that, the crucial auction order is now set in stone. It is D-Day. After the break, we will be back as the very first house, Alex and Corbin's, goes up for auction.
Next, Alex and Corbin's house goes up for auction, live.
Been 12 demanding weeks for our teams. This is the Block NZ Grand Live Auction Finale, and what a huge ride it has been for our four couples. Let us not underestimate what a huge night it is for them tonight.
It certainly has been, Shannon, but this moment right now belongs to our openers. Let's call them Alex and Corbin. Before the break, it was Marie and James that told you to. You would be putting your house up for auction first. How do you feel about that?
Oh, we're happy with first, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, we've always thought that, the order always makes it a bit of a lottery, and
We don't really feel like the order's going to make a difference to the people who have already decided that they want to buy our house, so.
If you had the choice, though, what would you have done?
If we had the choice, it probably would have been first or second, so, yeah.
We're pretty happy.
We're pretty happy.
I saw just before you were talking about you were baking a cake. Is the cake baked, and what sort of cake is it? Is it a very expensive wedding cake, let's say?
I think it's a 1.8 metre tall wedding cake that you just want to destroy, and it's perfectly iced by Alex here.
It's got a lot of detail. That took a lot of time, and it was so close to tipping over.
Well, let's hope someone jumps out of it waving cash in front of your eyes then, shall we? Now, I think it's very important to make it clear right now to all of us here that just like any auction, you two know your reserve price. And it's not until your house sells, and I'm not going to say if, I'm going to say when it sells, that the rest of us will find out just what that reserve price was and therefore how much money you have hopefully made. Mm-hmm. And speaking of value, I know this was a surgical procedure and there was a lot of planning that went into this. Did you think about the area you were in, the type of house this could be, and the value that it could go for, and did that steer how you went about styling it and creating it?
Mm. Absolutely. I mean, Point Chev is a pretty upmarket suburb. It's got a lot of capital growth in the area already to come, so we definitely focus pretty strongly on our market and who our potential buyer would be.
Mm. Who are they?
Well, we think that they're professionals, probably, or professionals with a young family. Maybe people that are time poor but love creative, they love nice things. Mm. And I think they really love the fact that Point Chev is a beautiful community kind of area and great schools, etc.
Yeah.
I said it was a surgical procedure.
Yeah.
Did you finish off? Do you haven't left any unsightly scars? Is it what you wanted it?
I wouldn't have the smile on my face right now if I wasn't 100% content with what we've achieved.
Yeah.
We went in with ambitious plans and we executed those plans really well, and we're really, really happy about that.
Mm. You ready?
Yep.
Yeah.
That's a big sigh there, Corbin.
Oh, it's been a long, long 12 weeks, so
this
yeah, we're
is the
ready.
Moment.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, this is the moment that we throw Alex and Corbin's house over to their auctioneer, Daniel Coulson, as Alex and Corbin's house goes under the hammer live now.
Well, folks, proudly representing the good team at Bailey's Real Estate, your trio of marketing agents, both Andrea and Duncan Ritchie, and indeed Luke McCaw, we offer you the fine property right here at number 28. Of course, it's more formally described to you as 355 square metres of freehold land, but known to you, me and the postman as house number 3. I think when we look at the property that's on offer, you know that this is exactly where contemporary design enjoys a harmonious relationship with the clean lines and, of course, the trusted condition of brick and weatherboard. We absolutely love the fact that it's got all of those non-negotiables, the double garaging, the generous bedrooms that are on offer, of course that open plan living spaces. But what I suggest to you is that number 28 is certainly an adult piñata. It is absolutely packed with goodies, and indeed when we say to you that you've got names like Peter Hay, Tom Dixon, Bauhaus and Fletcher, it is not a guest list of an exclusive party, it is the spec sheet of number 28. From natural marble bench tops, wireless Bose audio, and of course the white American oak flooring, it doesn't get much better than this. And although Alex and Corbin tell me that the wine fridge will be empty, I can tell you that there are the tune of $25,000 worth of upgrades in that kitchen. You will not find better on the block than what I can offer you right here. Folks, you walk outside, you open your nostrils, you let the sea breeze come through, you know you'll ensconce yourself, your family here at number 28, and you will never ever want to leave. This is your opportunity to realise the dream of Alex and Corbin. Naturally, we wish them the very best of luck. Good luck to you buyers as well. I simply put it in your hands for an opening bid or offer to start us away. Where do you see it? You call me an offer to go. 900 would be good buying, sir. Don't blame you at all. At $900,000, we get it underway immediately. Look, my suggestion at this point would be 950 the money. I appreciate it at $950,000, $1 million the immediate retort here. I bet it away at one even now. Is it $1,050,000 to nudge it forward, or are we done? 1050 is the ladies' offer, sir. Do we say 1.1 on your behalf? 1.1, all you've got to do is ask, and $1,100,000 is it $1,150 on your behalf? 1.15 is the money, and 1.2 is the obvious step to take. 1.2 is the offer again in the front row. Do we say 1250 to go, sir? First call at $1,200,000, the winning offer here. I bid it away then twice and it goes at $1,250,000, just in the nick of time. 1.3 is the obvious step, though you go there if you will. I bid it away at $1,250,000 now, or $1,250,000. Do I say 1.3 on your behalf, or at $1,250,000? At 1.3 on the offer here, I bid it away at $1.3 million and 50 the move. $1,350,000 is the offer, appreciated, sir, and 1.4 is where. 1.4 is the offer now, and $1,450,000 if you go there. I've got $1.4 million only for it now. First call at $1,400,000. Is there any better offer before it goes? Twice then, $1,450,000. So do we say 1.5 on your offer? Do we go to $1.5 million for you? I've got $1,450,000. Change your mind as many times as you like till the hammer comes down. Once it has, you can't. I've got $1.45 million and how many? Okay, $1,475,000 is the offer. Make it very easy for everyone else, though. At $1,475,000 bids here, do we say $1.5 million to go? First call at $1,475,000, or 1.75 now. Twice, 1.5. Appreciate it. $1,500,000. Is there any better offer? Man, good news. At 1.5, if there is no better offer, it is on the market and I sell it to you at that level. At $1,500,000, I bid it away at 1.5 and I look for a mere 25 to nudge it forward unless we're done. For 15.25, the offer here now, and 15.50 is where. I've got $1,525,000, just 25 more to go. First call at $1,525,000, man, best on the block. 35 is the offer then. $1,005,000 and 35. 45 is the appropriate response, though, sir. You look a good judge of quality to me. At 15.35, I bid it away first time. At 35 now, and 1.5 and 35 the offer. Twice at $1,535,000. Is there any better from the right? I bid it away at $1.535 million. Unless there's something better, I sell it. Third call then at $1,535,000. It is going. Unless there's a better. Sir, do we say five more? Do we go to 15.40 for you? Yes, $1,535,000 is the offer, and unless it's 1540, I sell the property away, and it goes at $1,535,000. This is Just in the nick of time. At $1,540,000, gee, I thought you had it there as well. $1,540,000 is the offer. I bid it away at $1.54 million, of course. 45 is the place to be. Nudge it along. 42, friendly gesture, I'm assuming. 42 is the offer. At 1.5 and 42, now do we say 45 to go? Just a mere $3,000 to nudge it forward. I bid it away at $1,542,000 and 15, 42 the money. First time at $1,542,000. Is there any better offer from you? Twice? I bid it away once. It's gone, it's gone. Third call at $1,542,000. I sell it here unless there's a better offer.
$8,000.
Beautiful. 50's the offer at $1,550,000. Look, I wouldn't be arguing with his judgment on quality here. 1,550's the offer. Look, we look for 52 or 55. You tell me. Don't let me limit you for a second. 52's the offer. Appreciate it once again at $1,552,000. Do we say 60, sir? Do we nudge it along for you now? I bid it away at 1,552,000 and I look for $1,560,000, if you will. First call at $1,552,000. Twice I sell it unless there's a better offer than $1,552,000 quickly or it goes. $1,000? You can't value it that closely. If you can, you're in the wrong job. I bid it away at $1,552,000. Do we say 53 on your behalf or do I sell it quickly or it goes? Third call at 1552,000. It is selling. Selling. Gone to you. Congratulations. Very well done indeed. A fine result for you. Sir, congratulations to you. Congratulations, of course, must go to Alex and Corbin for their sterling effort. Folks, I wish the very best of luck to the rest of you this evening.
What a start, guys. Congratulations.
Hey, thanks, Mike. Unbelievable.
227, I believe,
oh
is it?
Oh, my gosh.
Your mathematician's better than mine, Corbin.
What was the final bet? I don't even know.
I think we're about $227,000 in the can.
Oh, my gosh.
Now, hang on. Hold on.
So amazing.
You think you might be able to add $80,000 to that and you're over the $300,000 marks. You could be the biggest winners in block history. As you sit here right now, if you are the winners tonight, are you confident?
At this point, $80,000 doesn't matter. It is absolutely incredible.
It would be amazing, but honestly, we're so happy. We cannot believe that result.
It is mind-blowing. Yeah.
I was watching you, Alex, and you were getting a little emotional there, and when it went up and when it started selling, Mr. Cool, Calm and Collected Superman here. I didn't know what to make of what was going on. How were you feeling?
I still think they got an absolute bargain. Like, I know what's gone into that house. I know, they're really good buying, and I credit to them, though. I mean, we're super happy. Like, that is a hell of a lot of money.
Yeah.
Well, I got to say, I personally sat in there the other day, and I think whoever has bought that has bought that at a very good price.
Yeah.
They are getting a bargain because the work that has gone into that is quite extraordinary and you two should be very proud of yourselves. And I say congratulations. Does it make it all worthwhile? Does it make the time that you didn't finish the living room okay now?
Yeah, absolutely.
This is the exact reason why we didn't rush it and we tried to deliver something beautiful and... Thanks.
Okay, well, let's head back out to Shannon now, who is with the others. It'll be so interesting, Shannon, to see what they make of all of that.
Absolutely, what a way to kick things off, a $227,000 profit, guys. What does that kind of start make you feel like?
Oh my God. Incredible though, that's so good. Happy for them.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Now, Corbin did say that the buyer still got a bargain. Is that typical of Corbin or do you think they definitely still got a bargain?
Oh.
He's all right.
He's all right. To a TA. He's a good man and he has faith in his own work and he should do as well.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Well, seeing awesome. You guys support each other really makes it all that much more worthwhile. But Marie and James, you have made the decision here.
Yeah.
You two are up next. Yeah. After witnessing what just happened during that first auction, how are you feeling?
Oh. The nerves are still, the heart's racing. And it's
just so crazy what just happened. And it's real, you know, this is it. This is all the work we've been, you know, everything we've been doing the last 12 weeks, it's all about now.
It may have felt like a sleep-deprived dream up until this point, but it's very much real. And we will be back very, very soon as the tension builds towards our second auction.
After the break, Marie and James's street side house goes under the hammer live.
RNZ Grand Live Auction Finale, where Alex and Corbin have kicked things off in exceptional fashion with a massive $227,000 profit. Guys, have you had enough time to process it?
No.
Yeah. That is a lot of money to process.
Yeah. I think that profit reflects these very nice earrings that you've got here.
Maybe I could get the real one.
All right, well, we are all in good spirits here, but it's only one house down, three more to go, where Marie and James are now waiting very patiently for their house to go up for auction.
What a start by the openers, eh? Now we move into middle order. Let's see if they can build upon that, because it's Marie and James who decided the order. So first of all, why second?
We just talked to our real estate agent, and just based on the feedback we've been given on the open home, this is where they thought we should be. So we agreed and we chose two.
So what was the motivation for making Alex and Corbin go first then?
There was no motivation really. I think they were comfortable going first, and it was just what happened, the way we thought it would work out best for everyone is the order we picked.
Now, you don't need to tell anyone, and please don't tell anyone, but you know what your reserve price is. Are you confident?
Yeah, it seems like a bit of a bargain, really. I mean, if someone picks it up for that, it'll be a bit of a steal.
Well, let's hope they get it for proper value then, shall we? How are you feeling?
Nervous, yeah, really nervous. It's everything we've worked for in the last 12 weeks, but at the same time excited because it sounds like there's some people who love the house.
Now let's forget how you guys are feeling. How's Martin feeling right now?
Oh, Martin's out there. He's probably feeling just as nervous, but I'm a little bit worried about my dad. He was pretty nervous when I saw him earlier.
Okay, well, I think it's about time we handed Marie and James's Pacifica Paradise over to their auctioneer, Richard Valentine, as we see if this house will go just as well as the last house.
Good evening, I'm Richard Valentine, and I'm thrilled to offer Marie and James property at number 26, proudly marketed by Peter Tanner and Karen Clark of Bailey's. The property is aptly described Pacifica Paradise, a theme running right throughout the home, which has been constructed with flair and care and a wide appeal to discerning buyers who value smart technology, the open, bright and light living spaces flowing seamlessly to the outdoors for al fresco dining and, of course, a very safe haven for children to play. The state-of-the-art kitchen certainly is the hub of the home that interconnects with the superb gallery directly behind, and also having access from the very large internal garaging for your convenience. Complemented by luxurious accommodation on the second level, the sunny master suite is reminiscent of an island retreat, complete with a walk-in wardrobe and, of course, the beautifully appointed ensuite as well, plus the bonus of a highly spec bathroom for your family or guests' pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, it's all about lifestyle, it's all about location, and it is said home is where the heart is, and this home certainly has a very, very big heart. On that note, it's yours for the bidding. Calling for opening bids to start me away.
1.27.
1,275,000 will start me away. Don't let it put you off. 1,275,000 will look for 1.3. At 1,3, the bid is down here. At 1,300,000, the bid away. 1,325,000, bid's down here at the moment. 1,325,000. At 1,350,000, bid down here.
25.
Sorry?
25, a quarter.
I've got 325 down here, so that will take me to 50 at 1,325,000. First call at 1,325,000. Second call at 1,350,000. I'm bid. 1,350,000 the bid now, and 1,375,000. 1,375,000 I'm bid. Round me at 1,4 if you will. At 1,375,000 representing 1,425,000. 1,425,000 representing excellent value here at 1,425,000. First call at 1,425,000. Second call at 1,425,000. Third, final call, all done. 450? 450 I'm bid. Straight back at 475 or round me at 1,5. $1,450,000. I hold the bid down here against the couple down here. $1,450,000. 75, or we say 1.5 on your behalf. 1,450,000. I'll wait for you. I'll give you a moment. I won't take a 5. I'll take a 10. 1,450,000. The bid's here. 1,450,000. All done at 1,450,000. Once, twice, third and final call. Bidding. Give you a moment to consider your opportunity here. 1,450,000. If you give me a 10, I'll try. Are you on the market? 1,450,000. Bits here. All done at 1,450,000. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll put the property on the market. 1,450,000 if I want of a better bid at 1,450,000. Bidding away. Bids here at 1,450,000. It's against you at the moment. 1,450,000. 455. You're a tough negotiator. 460 straight back. 1,460,000. At 1,460,000, take comfort from the competition. 1,460,000. First call at 1,460,000. Second call at 1,460,000. I won't take a one. 1,460,000. All finished at 1,460,000. The auctioneer regulates the bidding from time to time as he or she sees fit, and I will regulate the bidding. 1,460,000. Bids here. Take that five if you will. Once, twice. Third and final call. It's going. All done, it's going. Why not? 1,461,000. Hold on. 65 is over here. 1,465,000. Take 1,000. 466. 470?
Yes.
470. Go on, you started this, you should finish it. 1,470,000, the bidder's down here. Can you judge it that closely? With respect, at 1,470,000, representing fantastic value. 1,470,000, bids here, once, twice, heard its time, all done, it is going. Can confirm your bid? 1,470,000, I hold the bid here on the left. It's had its time. 1,470,000. Out it goes. Once, twice, third, final call. You sure? One more might do it. One over's the place to be. 1,470,000. Would you miss it for 1,000?
Yeah, we'll do nothing.
471. 472. Well, I think this is amazing value when you compare the last lot. 1,472,000 is the bid holding over here, but I sell it, it goes. At 1,472,000, in or out, once, twice, third, final call, all done. Bidding, it's going. Confirm? Finished? Thank you very much. I salute you. 1,472,000, it is going. Going, it is sold here. Congratulations.
Oh,
thank you to my underbidder. Well done.
100 and you're not going to cry, are you? $147,000.
Oh my gosh. It's crazy.
It's unreal, Mike.
A bit of squabbling going on there, wasn't there?
Oh, yeah. It showed us that two people have loved that house as much as we have in our team. So that's all I could have asked for, is that someone fell in love with that house.
Well, you're in second place, so you can't win the extra $80,000. But are you truly happy with that? Can your competitive spirit actually take that, Marie?
I am so happy with that. You know, I've walked away and I've come away with so much experience and just more confidence in both of us and what we can do. And the money is bonus. I just can't believe that has just happened.
It's an incredible amount of money.
Yeah. That's really going to change a lot of things for both of us.
I think when I door knocked you guys in Papatoa there, you were doing up that house, weren't you?
Yeah. It's going on the house.
It's going on the house.
Maybe a trip.
I'll tell you what, you know how to make it go a long way too, won't you?
Yeah, we will.
You'll have the nicest house, the flashiest house in Papatoa, I can promise you that, when you spend that.
Oh, wow, this is just crazy. Yeah, just thank you for picking us to come here.
Well, Marie, you came and you played, and you played hard, and you've walked away with some good money. Congratulations to the both of you.
Thank you.
Well done, mate.
Thanks, mate.
Wonderful stuff.
Appreciate it, cheers.
Well, Shannon, we'll head back to you and the others, and the great news is that we're making money here tonight. Let's hope it continues.
We are making money here tonight, and $147,000, Marie, that is quite the bonus of being on the Block NZ, guys.
Watching it go up 1,000 by 1,000 by 1,000, how does that make you feel?
That was hard to watch, eh?
Yeah.
I'm so happy for them, eh?
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah,
it's
amazing. Well, it's started very well here on the Block NZ live auction final. Quinn and Ben, you are up next. Has watching those first two houses go made it easier or harder for you right now?
It made me shake.
Your voice is trembling.
I know. All of a sudden, I mean, final day, and now I'm really nervous.
Well, there's a very supportive crew here on the Block NZ for you guys, and we will be back after the break as Quinn and Ben's house goes up for auction. See you soon.
Next, it's auction time for Quinn and Ben, live on the Block NZ.
The Block NZ Grand Live Auction Finale, where Marie and James's house has just sold for a $147,000 profit, guys. A great sum of money, right?
Oh, it's incredible. Yeah.
An incredible amount of money, but not quite enough to take the lead from Alex and Corbin. They have a $227,000 profit, which means they are still in the running for that additional $80,000. But we will leave things over to Quinn and Ben as we see how the auction of House One goes.
We certainly are, Shannon, and Quinn and Ben are standing with me right now, and you've stood out there. I think three is a really difficult spot. How do you feel about it?
We actually would have preferred to have number three, actually.
Really?
So, yeah, we're pretty happy with where we're sitting.
Yeah.
Why is that? What's the rationale there?
I just don't know, just to see how everything else goes and, yeah, just hope that there's still going to be people in there with money left.
Tell us your thoughts as you're standing out there and all of a sudden you see Alex and Corbin's house go for so much profit. What did you think?
Yeah, I was shocked. I started shaking as soon as I saw that number, and I'm so happy for them though, because, man, they deserve it.
After that, a little bit of a trend down, although it's good money. How does that make you feel?
Look, I think it's a totally different kettle of fish. The people buying the front houses to the back houses. You know, some people want the street frontage, and some people want the privacy at the back. So, you know, I think some people might be saving their money for these back houses.
Well, let's hope that's true. Now, if you do win some good money, I think it's going to go on making your house a baby-proof house. How have you felt, Quinn, about so many people in the country enjoying your ride into pregnancy for the first time with you?
Yeah, it's been pretty cool. It's quite unique, I guess. But it's been so nice. We've had so much support, and people keep just sending us gifts and giving us advice and just been so, so kind towards us. And it's been really special.
Well, in about 3 months' time will be, I can promise you, the most important moment and the greatest moment in your lives so far. But how does this one feel right now?
I think we're pretty nervous now. It's been building, but just peaking at the moment, eh?
Okay, well, I wish you the best of luck, because it's time now to hand over to the auctioneer, who is Blair Cashmore, as Quinn and Ben's house goes under the hammer.
Well, good evening, everybody. Blair Cashmore is my name, and along with a good team from Bailey's, Blair Haddo and Victoria Williams, I welcome you to the auction at number 26A, of course, house number one. Quinn and Ben's labour of love, of course, and obviously it has been a lot harder than the labour Quinn is about to endure in the very, very near future. I'm sure she will debate me on that one. A home of irresistible style, it is very contemporary, it is fresh, it is clean, and of course it does have the simple lines. But the best aspect I find about this property is that there is still some potential left here for you, the buyer. It is a property that is very, very easy to fall in love with. I certainly did that this morning when I went to the property. And basically, you are buying a turnkey product. Just move in and enjoy the transformation that has been provided, and perhaps add your own style to it as you go forward. Fantastic storage throughout the property, including in all of the three bedrooms. That master room upstairs, of course, being a fantastic haven, especially with the open deck just outside of the room. The hub of the home, of course, being the large central island in the kitchen, which flows easily through to the living and dining and off to the outdoors as well. And you can even close off that extra lounge if need be, if you want more space and quiet from the children. Plus, you've got to remember, you do have the bonus of that extra park in there as well. So perhaps you've got a boat or a trailer, you do have the room to facilitate that. The sunny deck is fantastic, especially for that summer entertaining, of course. Step down from there and you're on the lawn. Not quite your quarter of kiwi acre, folks, but there is a big enough lawn to have the odd game of backyard cricket. But children, please do mind that picture window. If you're going to be like Corey Anderson, you might want to use the soft balls in this particular area. Tucked away beautifully down the rear of the site, so it is very private. So again, as you saw the other evening, you can easily remove your clothing just like the two Bens did as well. An immaculate home, folks. A practical yet unfussy design is what is on offer, and it does have a real feel-good factor. So do make it yours today, folks. And let's face it, it is not about room reveals. It is about what it offers you, folks. And hey, just look at what your neighbours sold for. Fantastic opportunity today. Let's move straight into it, ladies and gentlemen. You start the bidding away. I'll take you away from there. Who's got a starting bid for me? 800 there. What was the other one over there? 900. That sounds way better than the 8. 950, I'll take it. 9.5, 950, I've got. What about 1 million? One I've got on the phone there. 1 million, 1 million 50, may I say now? 1 million, it's on my right-hand side. How are we tracking on the left? 1 million 50 there. 1-1, 1-1, I've got it. Sounds way better there. 1,100,000. What about 150, may I say now? 1-1, it's there. 1,100,000, in or out now on my right-hand side. 50, we've got new bidder there. 50. Beat you over here. 1,150,000. Take two though. 1.2 it is. At 1,200,000. What about 1,250? Can I say now? At 1,250 it is. At 1,250 and 3, may I say? 1,250 is here already. Taking 3 now. 1,300,000, may I say? 1,250,000 on the left clearly now. 1.3, may I say? At 1,250,000. Done and out then. First time. At 1,300,000, I've got there. Good decision there. 50 again, madam, may I say, down here. At 1.3, it's there. 50 surely now again. Look what the neighbours did, folks. At 1,300,000, it's here on the phone, be clear. At 1,300,000, I'll help you out, madam. Can I say a quarter from there, perhaps? 25, may I say? Treat everybody the same at 1,300,000 on the phone. Looking for 25, though, ladies and gentlemen. 25, yes? 10. I'd rather have a 25. That sounds way better. Take your 10, then. 25, may I say now? 25 on the phone? 1,310 it is, on my left-hand side. Looking for 25 now, folks. At 1,310,000, in or out, ladies and gentlemen. Anywhere else, feel free to join in if you like it. At 1,310,000. 25 I need, though. How are we going on the phone? Fantastic buy in there. At 1,310,000, in or out now, at 1,310,000. First time then at 1.310. Second call, third and final time. Done, finished it out. 25, sir? 20. 30, can I say now? 1,320,000. Round meter 50 on the phone, may I say? What about 50? 50 sounds way better. At 1,320,000 on the left-hand side there. Take the 30 though, no problem at all. At 1,320,000, in or out, ladies and gentlemen, the bid is there. Should we go a 5? Yes, they shall. At 1,320,000, I need to work a little bit harder, ladies and gentlemen. Not quite there. At 1,320,000 on the left-hand side. In or out now. First time then at 1,320,000. Second call. I'm jumping the gun here. It's 2, not 3. Third and final time at 1,320,000. Done, out and finished then. Any further advances on that, folks? Holding for a minute on the phone. Give them a little bit of time. Yes. 1,325,000. 30, may I say, sir? Well, take me to 50. Can I say 50? 30 it is. 1,330,000. 5 again. At 1,330,000, clearly here on my left-hand side. And again, are we? Talk amongst yourselves while they're on the phone. It's fine, ladies and gentlemen. Must be a bad line. At 1,330,000. In or out? Do we have a decision there, Blair? What's another 5 in the whole scale of things? 1,000. 5, may I say, sir? Can I say 3,500? 1,331,000. Can I say 5? 5 it is, thank you for that. 1,335,000. 6? At 1,335,000, in or out, ladies and gentlemen? that helps them make the decision. We can sell at this level, ladies and gentlemen. It's on the market for sale at $1,335,000. Are we done, finished and silent, ladies and gentlemen? I sell away then if I have no further bids than that. At $1,335,000, it's there. We are on the market, yes. In or out now, playing for keeps here. $1,335,000 done. Finish then. Another 1,000 will do the trick. Well, it mightn't do the trick. I'd prefer it to be a five. Mightn't do the trick for them. Take your six, though, no problem at all. Could be the one. Bring it in. I can wait all night. I don't know what time we finish, but... 1,335,000 it goes then, ladies and gentlemen, for the want of a better bid. I sell away then at 1,335,000 in or out. Have we finished there? Done. Out, sir. Could be your lucky day here. At 1,335,000 it goes then for the first time. I sell away. Are you done, ladies and gentlemen? Second call, it goes. Third and final time, it's going. Going, it's...
You're out.
Sold there. 1,335,000. Thank you very much, and thank you to the contestants.
Well, the house is sold and you've made $10,000, which is, well, nothing to turn your noses up at.
Okay.
I know you would have wanted to make more than that, especially what's happened that's gone before. How do you feel about it right now?
Well, look, obviously we were hoping for a bit more than that, but the whole experience has been absolutely amazing.
Yeah.
You can't put money on that, on what we've, you know, learned and what we've been through, so...
It's all good, and 10 grand is a lot of money.
I think
it really is.
In my eyes, you know, we're already winning in life, so.
You certainly are. I think a lot of people around the country look at you guys and are very jealous of what you two have, mm-hmm. and you know what I'm talking about there, and what's to come as well.
Thank you, Mark.
And hopefully this will go to war. I mean, you can buy a lot of nappies with $10,000. I can promise you.
Sure.
promise you that. Look, guys, you have been rookies. Do you think that you were hamstrung a little bit by the lack of challenge wins? If you had some advice for maybe the next people through about the importance of winning challenges.
I'm not really sure. Like, if we had any more money, I'm not sure what we would have done differently. Like, the house is to an amazing standard. Like, sure, the decorating, you know, we're not amazing at that, but anyone can come in and change that. So someone's got an awesome deal there.
They certainly have.
Yeah.
And I think that's the message, Shannon. Well, these guys will walk away with $10,000. Someone's walking away with an absolute bargain, in my opinion.
I think, in all of our opinions as well, an absolute bargain, but they do have a very positive way at looking at things. $10,000 still, guys, which means, Alex and Corbin, you are still in the running for that extra 80K. How does it make you feel after seeing that, though?
It's really sad.
Oh. Yeah, so disappointed for them.
I mean, yeah.
They deserve so much more than that. It's really gutting.
That house is worth way more than that. Yeah. But, I mean... Yeah.
Oh, but like Mark said, a lot of people are very envious of what those two have anyway.
Yeah.
Now, Joe and Damo, they are up next, and I know that tension is most definitely building after seeing that. We will be back as their house goes up for auction.
Coming up, Joe and Damo's house goes up for sale in our live auction.
Welcome back to the Block NZ Grand Live Auction Finale, a night where we know anything can and will happen. Quinn and Ben's house has just sold with a 10K profit, leaving Alex and Corbin in the running for that additional 80K. However, there is still one more house to go under the hammer, so we will leave it over to Joe and Damo to see if they can now take the lead.
Here we go, our fourth and final auction. It's Joe and Damo, and let's face it, you guys are already winners, aren't you, tonight?
Yeah.
Got an amazing car, so thanks to all the support out there for getting us that far, so it's been an amazing night.
Yeah. Right, you've seen what's just happened. We started off gangbusters,
then
we went very well, and then we dropped off. How does that make you feel in fourth position, having watched that?
Quite nervous. Yeah, it is quite nerve-wracking. It's pretty scary.
I can tell because you're shaking.
I thought that was Damo.
Yeah, it's shaking.
Damo, this is as close to you ever breaking as I've ever seen you, to tell you the truth.
I might even cry tonight. You never know.
I want to take you right back to that first challenge. You won the right to select the houses, and you selected this house.
Yeah.
You still Every time I've asked you, you've said, I still back that decision. Do you still back that decision?
Yeah, we still back it.
Yes, it's just an amazing house with all its views and the privacy, and it's something we would love to own ourselves. So we built that house around that sort of love and a homely sort of place, so, and we left it at that. And so hopefully there's a buyer out there who sees the same.
I don't want this to be taken as being disparaging or disrespectful to small town New Zealand. Where you guys come from, but you have put some serious big smoke swank into that joint, haven't you?
Yep, we have.
Yeah. Good old hello, Fielding. Hello, Danny Vick.
Are you ready, guys?
Yes, we're ready.
Okay, well, here we go. It's time to hand the fourth and final auction over to Sabina Davison, and she is going to try her hardest to sell Joe and Damo's house.
Well, very, very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And on behalf of Karen Spires and Ben Meering, I introduce you to 28A, better known as House 4 on the block. Now, it was the very first pick on the block. This, the sunniest house, of course, has been positioned and designed to create the very, very, very best of indoor and outdoor living. On entry, you're greeted immediately with a sense of welcoming space. The replacement of the wall with those gorgeous, gorgeous timber beams, well, that was described as one of the riskiest moves on the block ever. You'll agree, it really has paid off. Absolute genius, I would suggest to you. Now, first equal winners of Room Reveals, Joe and Damo's home, of course, is a statement. I think Joe and Damo wouldn't say effortless, but I would say effortless design style. That's luxurious, it's practical, superb use of space that we have, the calming colours to provide a home that's either a sanctuary or an entertainer's delight at will. Beautiful flow to the outdoors where there are a myriad of enjoyment options, be it an outdoor dinner party or barbecue on a warm summer eve, soak in the spa pool, a space for kids to play safely, or perfect even as a Wolverine's runabout space if you intend keeping one as a pet. As I think might have been brought up once or twice on some of the earlier episodes. Only House on the Block, of course, that offers that full second living area upstairs. Once again, that provides so much flexibility and relaxation options. Some of you buyers have even suggested it lends itself to conversion, perhaps to a fourth bedroom. So, ladies and gentlemen, buyers, what's it to be? I'm in your hands for an opening bid, opening offer. At 1 million, 1 million and 50, do I see it? 1 million opening bid. At 1 million and 50, I have now 1 million and 50, make it 1-1 where? At 1 million and 1-1. 1-1 and 150, I hear, and 1.375. That's the way to bid and buy property, loving your work at the back there. At 1,375, do I take you to 1.4 from there? 1,375 bid. Don't let it intimidate you, folks. It underpins value here. That demand at 1,375, beautiful home. Once I call it at 1,375, do I see 1.4 where? Where's all the action? Had it all in the front row. Don't let them buy on just the one bid, folks. At 1,375, once, twice. Third time, would it make a difference if I told you I'm selling it away at 1,375,000? We're on the market. Take me along to 1.4 still, maybe even 10. Do I see at 1,375,000? Quickly now, be in. Once at 1,375,000, twice. Absolutely fantastic buying. It's against the rules to let them only bid once. Well, that's what I thought anyway. Did you read that out earlier? At 1,375,000, what about a $5,000 bid? Be in to win here. Wonderful value at the level. Twice, third, final time at 1,375,000. Even a single I'll take. It's going. Oh, single is it? 376. 80 at the back, or go to 1.4. 386. Make it 90, madam. I didn't quite hear it. She said something about a husband. Make him very, very happy, madam. Bid again is what I'd recommend to you. At 1,386,000. Great buying. I still suggest 1.4, but I'm taking the single. What about even 500? You never know. At 1,386,000, you know how it works. Once, $1,386,000. Twice, $1,386,000. Third final time, madam, you don't want to end up in a divorce. I suggest you buy the house. At $1,386,000, I've called it for the third time. Have to be fair. It's going. Are you sure? I need to know. Yes or no, madam? It's going.
He said yes.
He said yes. It is. Quickly, yes. Peter, instructions? Yes. Sold. Congratulations. Commiserations, of course, to the underbidders. That's the final auction of the block. Have a fantastic evening.
I just want to put that figure in your head now. Forget about everything that's gone on this evening. Forget about the first two auctions. $61,000. How does it feel?
That's a huge amount of money. That's awesome. We're really happy. Yeah.
Does it make it worthwhile?
Oh, it's more than worthwhile. Even if we hadn't made any money tonight, it's an amazing experience, and we're more than grateful for our opportunity. But $61,000, we'll take that.
You'll take it. That's fantastic. Your house is sold. And you had so much fun along the way, I think, didn't you?
We did, yeah. It's been an incredible journey. Unreal. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, and throw a Honda CR-V Sport on top of it.
Yay!
Oh, that's a pretty good going for 12 weeks' work, I think.
Yeah, a car. You won the car and you took home $61,000. Congratulations.
Yeah,
but we know what that means, Shannon, is we have the winners. That's Alex and Corbin. They have won over $300,000. Oh. They're with you now. Let's get straight to them.
Yes, they have won a total of $307,000.
Yay!
Guys, that is the most on the Block NZ history.
Oh,
is that number making any sense to you right now?
It's not making much sense at all.
Yeah. Do you have something in your eye?
I do have
your eyes.
In my eye.
All right, guys. You are a team that all celebrate each other so well. Are you all feeling super proud of Alex and Corbin and each other?
Yeah. They've done such an awesome job and they deserve it.
There you go, guys.
We just want to say that we feel like you guys have just done the most amazing job ever, and we feel like we'd already won because we had made such great friends with everyone, our relationship had gotten better, and
so you get a lot more than you bargained for here on the Block. Now we will see you all after the break as we talk more with our winners of the Block NZ 2014, Alex and Corbin. See you soon. NZ live auction finale, where all four of our houses have sold here on auction night. Alex and Corbin taking out top prize.
What more, Shannon? We've actually made more money than ever before on the Block NZ. 307,000. I'll be saying that to you guys all night, to tell you the truth, until it actually probably sinks in.
It's incredible. It's mind-blowing. I can't even get my head around that amount of money.
You've had about 5 minutes now. Is it sinking in?
No. There's no words. I can't even talk. It's the most incredible thing.
Yeah. It's amazing. I mean, it's so bittersweet. We're, like, really, really happy, but we can't help but feel for especially Quinn and Ben, you know. They deserve so much more than $10,000 out of this.
And I think we'd really like to share a bit of what we have won with them.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, you're kidding me.
We would.
No, you don't have to.
No, we know how much work everyone has put in. Everyone's put the same amount of effort in, and it's just heartbreaking to see them walk away with 10 when they know we know that their house is worth so much more.
Mm.
And would like to gift them $30,000.
Mm. Oh, awesome. My God. You guys deserve it. You really do.
Are you serious?
Yeah. You really do deserve it. And we really want that for your family and for the amount of effort that you've put into your house. Your attitudes deserve so much more than what we're giving you and so much more than what that house has given you, you know? I think you really deserve it.
I'm blowing away.
I think we're all very blown away.
Absolutely flabbergasted.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Sorry.
Well, I don't think that'll ever be topped on the Block, to tell you the truth.
It's been
an absolute privilege to be a part of what you just did then.
Okay.
We didn't do it for TV or anything. We did it for Quinn and Ben.
We talked about it and we said if we won and someone else didn't win a lot of money that we would just, you have to share it. I mean, we have such good bond with all these guys. I mean, we've been on school camp with these guys for 3 months. And it's been a hell of a ride and we just think that, you know, everyone deserves something and they deserve so much more than that. But, you know, you guys are amazing. Probably the best attitude on the block. So full credit to you guys.
Yeah. Absolutely magnificent.
This is absolutely blowing all of us away.
Staggering.
You have thrown a spanner in the works, guys.
Just quickly to you, Joe and Damo, $61,000, OK, it comes in at third, but when you think about it, that is equivalent to what second place made last year.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, no, we're stoked with it. 61 grand, that's awesome. And, yeah, you guys did a... Bloody good on you for shooting around the cash.
Thank you.
You're doing awesome, this. Just kidding.
That's awesome. And of course, Marie and James, you have mentioned how much you have learned on the show, and not only that, you left with quite a nice bonus yourself as well. How are you feeling after all of this?
Oh, it's pretty incredible, and I guess what we've learned is how awesome the. These group of people are. I think
we have all learned right here in this moment how incredible this group of Blockaholics are this year. Congratulations to you all, guys. It is such a pleasure.
We're a family now.
Yeah, we are.
I thought I might have been able to get maybe a marriage, a proposal, or something like that. But I'll take what I just saw to tell you the truth. It makes me just as happy. Well, guys. It's been an emotional night and it's finished on, I think, one of the finest highs that you'll ever see on television. Congratulations to everyone. What an awesome performance from you two. That is just staggering and magnificent and it's a pleasure to know you. We've had so much fun bringing this show to you and good news, we'll be bringing you a series 4. Until then, good night. That's it.
Next time on the Block NZ, we take you behind the scenes.
One of my tradies.
So you can have it ribbed or smooth.
We'll take you back to where it all began, before the first hammer was even lifted.
Hey, Ryan, what's happening?
What are you doing there?
We'll show you the stuff that the contestants didn't want you to see.
He actually himself at the table.
And our contestants share their tips on how to get on the show for season 4 of The Block NZ.
Don't take your Crocs to the block.
Make sure you stick up for yourself and stay as the boss. Don't let your partner try and take over halfway through.
That's not a tip.
Yeah, it is. For all the men out there that might want to come on here, or women if they're the boss at home.
Don't listen to your partner when he tries to tell you that he's the boss, because that's not right.
Welcome back to the Block NZ Grand Live Auction Finale, a night where we know anything can and will happen. Quinn and Ben's house has just sold with a 10K profit, leaving Alex and Corbin in the running for that additional 80K. However, there is still one more house to go under the hammer, so we will leave it over to Joe and Damo to see if they can now take the lead.
Here we go, our fourth and final auction. It's Joe and Damo, and let's face it, you guys are already winners, aren't you, tonight?
Yeah.
Got an amazing car, so thanks to all the support out there for getting us that far, so it's been an amazing night.
Yeah. Right, you've seen what's just happened. We started off gangbusters.
Yeah.
Then we went very well, and then we dropped off. How does that make you feel in fourth position, having watched that?
Quite nervous. Yeah, it is quite nerve-wracking. It's pretty scary.
I can tell, because you're shaking.
I thought that was Damo.
Yeah, it's shaking.
Damo, this is as close to you ever breaking as I've ever seen you, to tell you the truth.
I might even cry tonight. You never know.
I want to take you right back to that first challenge. And you won the right to select the houses, and you selected this house.
Yeah.
You still, every time I've asked you, you've said, I still back that decision. Do you still back that decision?
Yeah, we still back it.
Yes, it's just an amazing house with all its views and the privacy, and it's something we would love to own ourselves. So. We built that house around that sort of love and a homely sort of place, so, and we left it at that. And so hopefully there's a buyer out there who sees the same.
I don't want this to be taken as being disparaging or disrespectful to small town New Zealand, where you guys come from, but you have put some serious big smoke swank into that joint, haven't you?
Yep. We have.
Yeah. Good old hello, Fielding. Hello, Danny Vick.
Are you ready, guys?
Yes, we're ready.
Okay, well, here we go. It's time to hand the fourth and final auction over to Sabina Davison, and she is going to try her hardest to sell Joe and Damo's house.
Well, very, very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And on behalf of Karen Spires and Ben Meering, I introduce you to 28A, better known as House 4 on the block. Now, it was the very first pick on the block. This, the sunniest house, of course, has been positioned and designed to create the very, very, very best of indoor and outdoor living. On entry, you're greeted immediately with a sense of welcoming space. The replacement of the wall with those gorgeous, gorgeous timber beams, well, that was described as one of the riskiest moves on the block ever. You'll agree, it really has paid off. Absolute genius, I would suggest to you. Now, first equal winners of Room Reveals, Joe and Damo's home, of course, is a statement. I think Joe and Damo wouldn't say effortless, but I would say effortless design style that's luxurious, has been positioned and designed to create the very, very, very best of indoor and outdoor living. On entry, you're greeted immediately with a sense of welcoming space. The replacement of the wall with those gorgeous, gorgeous timber beams, well, that was described as one of the riskiest moves on the block ever. You'll agree, it really has paid off. Absolute genius, I would suggest to you. Now, first equal winners of Room Reveals, Joe and Damo's home, of course, is a statement. I think Joe and Damo wouldn't say effortless, but I would say effortless design style that's luxurious, it's practical, superb use of space that we have, the calming colours to provide a home that's either a sanctuary or an entertainer's delight at will. Beautiful flow to the outdoors where there are a myriad of enjoyment options, be it an outdoor dinner party or barbecue on a warm summer eve, soak in the spa pool, a space for kids to play safely, or perfect even as a Wolverine's runabout space if you intend keeping one as a pet, as I think might have been brought up once or twice on some of the earlier episodes. Only House on the Block, of course, that offers that full second living area upstairs. Once again, that provides so much flexibility and relaxation options. Some of you buyers have even suggested it lends itself to conversion, perhaps to a fourth bedroom. So, ladies and gentlemen, buyers, what's it to be? I'm in your hands for an opening bid, opening offer. At 1 million, 1,000,050, do I see at 1 million opening bid? At 1,000,050, I have now 1,000,050, make it 1,1, where? At 1,000,000 and 1,1, 1,1 and 1,50, I hear, and 1.375. That's the way to bid and buy property, loving your work at the back there. At 1,000,375, do I take you to 1,4 from there? 1,000,375 bid. Don't let it intimidate you, folks. It underpins value here. That demand at 1,000,375, beautiful home. Once I call it at 1,000,375, do I see 1,4 where? Where's all the action? Had it all in the front row. Don't let them buy on just the one bid, folks. At 1,000,375, once, twice. Third time, would it make a difference if I told you I'm selling it away at 1,000,375? We're on the market. Take me along to 1,4 still, maybe even 10, do I see? At 1,000,375, quickly now be in. Once at 1,000,375. Twice. Absolutely fantastic buying. It's against the rules to let them only bid once. Well, that's what I thought anyway. Did you read that out earlier? At 1,000,375, what about a $5,000 bid? Be in to win here. Wonderful value at the level. Twice, third, final time at 1,000,375. Even a single I'll take. It's going.
Thank you, Mark.
And hopefully this will go to war. I mean, you can buy a lot of nappies for $10,000. I can promise you, promise you that. Look, guys, you have been rookies. Do you think that you were hamstrung a little bit by the lack of challenge wins? If you had some advice for maybe the next people through about the importance of winning challenges.
I'm not really sure. If we had any more money, I'm not sure what we would have done differently. Like, the house is to an amazing standard. Like, sure, the decorating, you know, we're not amazing at that, but anyone can come in and change that. So someone's got an awesome deal there.
They certainly have.
Yeah.
And I think that's the message, Shannon. While these guys will walk away with $10,000, someone's walking away with an absolute bargain, in my opinion.
I think, in all of our opinions as well, an absolute bargain, but they do have a very positive way at looking at things. $10,000 still, guys, which means, Alex and Corbin, you are still in the running for that extra 80K. How does it make you feel after seeing that, though?
It's really sad. Oh.
Yeah, so disappointed for them. Yeah. I mean, they deserve so much more than that. It's really gutting.
That house is worth way more than that. Yeah. But, I mean, yeah.
Oh, but like Mark said, a lot of people are very envious of what those two have anyway.
Yeah.
Now, Joe and Damo, they are up next, and I know that tension is most definitely building after seeing that. We will be back as their house goes up for auction.
Coming up, Joe and Damo's house goes up for sale in our live auction.
Welcome back to the Block NZ Grand Live Auction Finale, a night where we know anything can and will happen. Quinn and Ben's house has just sold with a 10K profit, leaving Alex and Corbin in the running for that additional 80K. However, there is still one more house to go under the hammer, so we will leave it over to Joe and Damo to see if they can now take the lead.
Here we go, our fourth and final auction. It's Joe and Damo, and let's face it, you guys are already winners, aren't you, tonight?
Yeah. Yeah,
got an amazing car, so thanks to all the support out there for getting us that far, so it's been an amazing night.
Yeah. Right, you've seen what's just happened. We started off gangbusters,
then
we went very well, and then we dropped off. How does that make you feel in fourth position, having watched that?
Quite nervous.
Yeah, it is quite nerve-wracking. It's pretty scary.
I can tell, because you're shaking.
I thought that was Damo.
Yeah, it's really shaking.
Damo, this is close to you ever breaking as I've ever seen you, to tell you the truth.
I might even cry tonight, you never know.
I want to take you right back to that first challenge. And you won the right to select the houses, and you selected this house.
Yeah.
You still, every time I've asked you, you've said, I still back that decision. Do you still back that decision?
Yeah, we still back it.
Yes.
Getting fantastic value. 1,470,000 bids here, once, twice, heard its time, all done, it is going. Can confirm your bid? 1,470,000, I hold the bid here on the left. It's had its time, 1,470,000, out it goes, once, twice, third, final call, you sure? One more might do it. One over's the place to be. 1,470,000, would you miss it 4,000? 471, 472. Well, I think this is amazing value when you compare the last lot. 1,472,000 is the bid holding over here, but I sell it, it goes. At 1,472,000, in or out, once, twice, third, final call, or done. Bidding, it's going. Confirm, finished. Thank you very much, I salute you. 1,472,000, it is going. Going, it is sold here. Congratulations.
Oh,
thank you to my underbidder. Well done.
100, and you're not going to cry, are you, James? $147,000.
Oh my gosh, it's crazy.
It's unreal, Mike.
A bit of squabbling going on there, wasn't there?
Oh, yeah. It showed us that two people have loved that house as much as we have in our team. So that's all I could have asked for, is that someone fell in love with that house.
Well, you're in second place, so you can't win the extra $80,000. But are you truly happy with that? Can your competitive spirit actually take that, Marie?
I am so happy with that. You know, I've walked away and I've come away with so much experience and just more confidence in both of us and what we can do. And the money is bonus. I just can't believe that has just happened.
That's an incredible amount of money.
Yeah. That's really going to change a lot of things for both of us.
I think when I door knocked you guys in Papatoa there, you were doing up that house, weren't you?
Yeah. It's going on the house.
It's going on the house.
Maybe a trip.
I'll tell you what, you know how to make it go a long way too, won't you?
Yeah, we will.
You'll have the nicest house, the flashiest house in Papatoa, I can promise you that, when you spend that.
Oh, wow, this is just crazy. Yeah, just thank you for picking us to come here.
Well, Marie, you came and you played, and you played hard, and you've walked away with some good money. Congratulations to the both of you.
Thank you.
Well done, mate.
Thanks, mate.
Wonderful stuff.
Appreciate it, cheers.
Well, Shannon, we'll head back to you and the others, and the great news is that we're making money here tonight. Let's hope it continues.
We are making money here tonight, and $147,000, Marie, that is...
Place. I bid it away once. It's gone, it's gone. Third call at $1,542,000. I sell it here, unless there's a better offer. Beautiful. 50's the offer. At $1,550,000. Look, I wouldn't be arguing with his judgment on quality here. 1,550's the offer. Look, we look for 52 or 55. You tell me. Don't let me limit you for a second. 52's the offer. Appreciate it once again. At $1,552. Do we say 60, sir? Do we nudge it along for you now? I bid it away at 1,552 and I look for $1,560, if you will. First call at $1,552,000. Twice I sell it, unless there's a better offer than $1,552, quickly or it goes. Sir, 1,000? You can't value it that closely. If you can, you're in the wrong job. I bid it away at $1,552. Do we say 53 on your behalf, or do I sell it quickly, or it goes third call at 1,552? It is selling. Selling. Gone to you. Congratulations. Very well done indeed. A fine result for you. Sir, congratulations to you. Congratulations, of course, must go to Alex and Corbin for their sterling effort. Folks, I wish the very best of luck to the rest of you this evening.
What a start, guys. Congratulations.
Hey, thanks, Mark. Unbelievable.
227, I believe,
oh
is
gosh.
It? Your mathematician's better than mine, Corbin.
What was the final bet? I don't even know.
I think we're about $227,000 in the can.
Oh, my gosh.
Now, hang on. Hold
so
on.
Amazing.
You think you might be able to add $80,000 to that and you're over the 300,000 marks. You could be the biggest winners in block history. As you sit here right now, if you are the winners tonight, are you confident?
At this point, $80,000 doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Absolutely incredible.
It would be amazing, but honestly, we're so happy. We cannot believe that result.
It is mind-blowing. Yeah.
I was watching you, Alex, and you were getting a little emotional there, and when it went up and when it started selling, mystical, calm and collected Superman here. I didn't know what to make of what was going on. How were you feeling?
I still think they got an absolute bargain. Like, I know what's gone into that house. I know, they're really good buying, and I credit to them, though. I mean, we're super happy. Like, that is a hell of a lot of money.
Yeah.
Well, I got to say, I personally sat in there the other day, and I think whoever has bought that at a very good price.
Yeah.
They are getting a bargain because the work that has gone into that is quite extraordinary, and you two should be very proud of yourselves. And I say congratulations. Does it make it all worthwhile? Does it make the time that you didn't finish the living room okay now?
Absolutely.
This is the exact reason why we didn't rush it and we tried to deliver something beautiful. Yeah. And thanks.
Okay, well, let's head back out to Shannon now.
I feel for especially Quinn and Ben, you know. They deserve so much more than $10,000 out of this. And
I think we'd really like to share a bit of what we have won with them.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, you're kidding me.
We would.
No, you don't have to.
No, we know how much work everyone has put in. Everyone's put the same amount of effort in, and it's just heartbreaking to see them walk away with 10 when they know we know that their house is worth so much more.
Mm.
And would like to gift them $30,000.
Mm. Oh, awesome. Oh my God!
You guys deserve it. You really do.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You really do deserve it. And we really want that for your family, and for the amount of effort that you've put into your house. Your attitudes deserve so much more than what we're giving you, and so much more than what that house has given you. You know, I think you really deserve it.
Oh, I'm blowing away.
I think we're all very blown away.
Absolutely fabulous.
Thank you so much.
Okay, sorry.
Well, I don't think that'll ever be topped on the block, to tell you the truth. It's been an absolute privilege to be a part of what you just did then.
Okay. We didn't do it for TV or anything. We did it for Quinn and Ben.
We we talked about it and we said if we won and someone else didn't win a lot of money that we would just, you have to share it. I mean, we have such good bond with all these guys. I mean, we've been on school camp with these guys for 3 months. And it's been a hell of a ride, and we just think that, you know, everyone deserves something, and they deserve so much more than that. But, you know, you guys are amazing. Probably the best attitude on the block, so full credit to you guys.
Yeah.
Absolutely magnificent.
This is absolutely blowing all of us away.
Staggering.
You have thrown a spanner in the works, guys.
Just quickly to you, John Damo, $61,000, OK, it comes in at third, but when you think about it, that is equivalent to what second place made last year.
Yeah.
Oh, no, we're stoked with it. 61 grand, that's awesome. And, yeah, you guys did a bloody good on you for shooting around the cash.
Thank you.
Yeah. You're awesome, doing this. Just kidding.
That's awesome.
And, of course, Marie and James, you have mentioned how much you have learned on the show, and not only that, you left with quite a nice bonus yourself as well. How are you feeling after all of this?
Oh, it's pretty incredible, and I guess what we've learned is how awesome these group of people are.
I think we have all learned right here in this moment how incredible this group of Blockaholics are this year. Congratulations to you all, guys. It is such a pleasure.
We're a family now.
Yeah, we are.
I thought I might have been able to get maybe a marriage, a proposal.
Well, there's a very supportive crew here on the Block NZ for you guys, and we will be back after the break as Quinn and Ben's house goes up for auction. See you soon.
Yay!
Next, it's auction time for Quinn and Ben, live on the Block NZ.
The Block NZ Grand Live Auction Finale, where Marie and James's house has just sold for a $147,000 profit, guys. A great sum of money, right?
Oh, it's incredible. Yeah.
An incredible amount of money, but not quite enough to take the lead from Alex and Corbin. They have a $227,000 profit, which means they are still in the running for that additional $80,000. But we will leave things over to Quinn and Ben as we see how the auction of House One goes.
We certainly are, Shannon, and Quinn and Ben are standing with me right now, and you've stood out there. I think three is a really difficult spot. How do you feel about it?
We actually would have preferred to have number three, actually.
Really?
So, yeah, we're pretty happy with where we're sitting.
Yeah.
Why is that? What's the rationale there?
I just don't know, just to see how everything else goes and, yeah, just hope that there's still going to be people in there with money left.
Tell us your thoughts as you're standing out there and all of a sudden you see Alex and Corbin's house go for so much profit. What did you think?
Yeah, I was shocked. I started shaking as soon as I saw that number, and I'm so happy for them because, man, they deserve it.
After that, a little bit of a trend down, although it's good money. How does that make you feel?
Look, I think it's a totally different kettle of fish, the people buying the front houses to the back houses. You know, some people want the street frontage, and some people want the privacy at the back. So, you know, I think some people might be saving their money for these back houses.
Well, let's hope that's true. Now, if you do win some good money, I think it's going to go on making your house a baby-proof house. How have you felt, Quinn, about so many people in the country enjoying your ride into pregnancy for the first time with you?
Yeah, it's been pretty cool. It's quite unique, I guess. But it's been so nice. We've had so much support, and people keep just sending us gifts and giving us advice and just been so, so kind towards us. And it's been really special.
Well, in about 3 months' time will be, I can promise you, the most important moment and the greatest moment in your life so far. But how does this one feel right now?
You know, I think we're pretty nervous now. It's been building, but, just peaking at the moment, eh?
OK, well, I wish you the best of luck, because it's time now to hand over to the auctioneer, who is Blair Cashmore, as Quinn and Ben's house goes under the hammer.
Well, good evening, everybody. Blair Cashmore is my name, and along with a good team...
Oh, don't!
So how are you feeling with the baby and all?
Quinn and Ben, 5.5 from Mark, 12.5, but disappointing. Week, last again.
After week,
More disappointment.
Same old story.
It's just called the mixture.
It didn't seem to matter what they tried. No one was buying it. The sentiment only soured when it came to marking Marie and James's Dinner Wars effort.
Cheers, guys. Cheers to Dinner Wars. Yeah. And may the best team win.
Yeah. Quinn and Ben scored your fun and your food particularly low.
Wow.
We feel like we had been stabbed in the back.
Mother.
So that's how it is.
But the sour taste didn't last long, and Quinn and Ben went back to doing what they did best, entertaining us.
Shall we see what goes into our tiles?
So ugly. As long as we get it all sealed up before the rain comes, because it's looking ominous. Yeah.
Does that word mean?
I know, I just heard people say it.
8 times brighter than what?
What?
A potato.
What?
And their sense of humour definitely won over the fans.
Look up and burn this. Burn it on the fence. Nice.
Despite not winning a single room on the block, they still have high hopes they can go all the way.
It's just going to change our life if we win this. We've only been married like 2 years and it would just set us up for life.
Yeah, our house at the moment probably isn't fit to look after a baby, but, you know, 80 grand, we could do a lot of things to that little house.
Next door, the fans are lined up at Marie and James's house.
Oh my God. It's crazy outside. It's pretty exciting. We're going to finally meet the fans of the block and everyone who's been supporting us.
You're my favourite.
But there was one special fan Marie was eager to impress.
So, what do you think, Dad?
Oh, it's quite cool. I like the mirror.
Yeah.
These cupboards?
Yeah, those are cupboards.
What's that, Maltika?
Yeah, that's Maltika bliss shiitake that we chose to do it. Peter Hay have been really smart about the way they use the storage in the kitchen. Mm. It's everywhere, like here, all the way around.
And I'm very, very proud of you, Marie.
Oh, thanks, Dad. I can tell by your smile.
What are you thinking?
Awesome.
Awesome.
Pacifica Paradise, a theme running right throughout the home, which has been constructed with flair and care and a wide appeal to discerning buyers who value smart technology, the open, bright and light living spaces flowing seamlessly to the outdoors for al fresco dining and, of course, a very safe haven for children to play. The state-of-the-art kitchen certainly is the hub of the home that interconnects with the superb gallery directly behind and also having access from the very large internal garaging for your convenience. Complemented by luxurious accommodation on the second level, the sunny master suite is reminiscent of an island retreat, complete with a walk-in wardrobe and, of course, the beautifully appointed ensuite as well, plus the bonus of a highly spec bathroom for your family or guests' pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, it's all about lifestyle, it's all about location, and it is said home is where the heart is, and this home certainly has a very, very big heart. On that note, it's yours for the bidding. Calling for opening bids to start me away. 1,275,000 will start me away. Don't let it put you off. 1,275,000 will look for 1,300,000. At 1,300,000, the bid is down here. At 1,300,000, the bid away. 1,325,000, bid's down here at the moment. 1,325,000. At 1,350,000, bid down here. 25. Sorry?
25, a quarter.
I've got 325 down here, so that will take me to 50 at 1,325,000. First call at 1,325,000. Second call at 1,350,000 I'm bid. 1,350,000 the bid now, and 1,375,000. 1,375,000 I'm bid. Round me at 1,400,000 if you will. At 1,375,000 representing 1,425,000. 1,425,000 representing excellent value here at 1,425,000. First call at 1,425,000. Second call at 1,425,000. Third, final call, all done. 450,000? 450,000 I'm bid. Straight back at 475,000 or round me at 1,500,000. 1,450,000. I hold the bid down here against the couple down here. 1,450,000. 75, or would you say 1.5 on your behalf? 1,450,000. I wait for you. I'll give you a moment. No, I won't take a 5. I'll take a 10. 1,450,000. The bid's here. 1,450,000. All done at 1,450,000. Once, twice, third and final call. Bidding. Give you a moment to consider your opportunity here. 1,450,000. If you give me a 10, I'll try. Are you on the market? 1,450,000. Bits.
Unless we've only been married like 2 years and it would just set us up for life.
Yeah, our house at the moment probably isn't fit to look after a baby. But, you know, 80 grand, we could do a lot of things to that little house.
Next door, the fans are lined up at Marie and James's house.
Crazy outside. It's pretty exciting. We're going to finally meet the fans of the block and everyone who's been supporting us.
You're my favourite. You guys have a great house.
But there was one special fan Marie was eager to impress.
So, what do you think, Dad?
Oh, it's quite cool. I like the mirror.
Yeah.
These cupboards?
Yeah, those are cupboards.
What's that, Maltika?
Yeah, that's Maltika bliss shiitake that we chose to do it. Peter Hay have been really smart about the way they use the storage in the kitchen. Mm. It's everywhere, like here, all the way around.
And I'm very, very proud of you.
Oh, thanks, Dad. I can tell by your smile.
What are you thinking?
Awesome.
Really good.
I love the front door. The front door's awesome. I want to touch it.
So you're more impressed this year than maybe last year?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think the work's just way up there. Last year was still good, but it's just like, wow.
Feedback's been sensational.
Yeah.
Like you and I, they all love the open space and feel and light brightness. They just feel that, you know, I think it's going to really appeal to a family.
Yeah, you just can't control it now. It's all out of our hands pretty much, and just got to wait and see.
Love this. You're on the block, NZ.
From the moment the dream came true.
Is this for real?
This is for real.
The ambition grew.
We're just going to bring everything. Team James and Marie, high five.
Moving into Streetside House 2.
Let's go and check out this view.
We were meeting one of the Block NZ's fiercest competitors, Marie.
We've got a lot more space than our next door neighbours at the front.
But at least their neighbours were dry.
James and Marie's tarpaulin is flapping away. And buckets of water are coming down.
Whoa!
Last to get their roof on meant keeping the water out early on was an impossible task.
Seal's going on tomorrow.
And when James didn't communicate his intentions to remove the tarps, it rained tears.
Our room is flooded. Do you care so much about this house? It is quite upsetting.
Inspired James.
Well done.
Go! And the winning feeling rolled on.
We won.
It's a boat.
Back in the winner's circle again, Marie and James.
They've created a modern Pacific theme with natural elements.
Gosh, this is so cool!
Pops of colour and technology at every turn.
Just tap the tuner button, straight away listen to radio.
Oh, no way! Oh my gosh!
They've wrapped a strong team around them.
What are you doing?
Oh, you're gonna love that.
And answered every demand that's been thrown at them.
Oh, it's yum. This has been an incredible journey. So many highs and then a few lows, but we've both proved to each other what it is that we can do. And I think we've both exceeded our expectations.
Are we having a baby?
No.
But one expectation hasn't been met.
I need to get
a ring for his name.
Hmm? Hmm? I'm pretty used to getting asked when I'm going to put a ring on it. I've been getting it from our family for like years and years, and our friends for years, and now get it from the Blockaholics as well.
You do get to a point you're like, maybe he's never gonna do it. And I joke to him about I will do it if he doesn't do it. So, yeah, I'll ask you if you don't ask me.
Maybe. I'll say no if you do it.
Up next, more verdicts from our open home visitors.
Joe and Davis was awesome. Views are colour.
And we're not far away from our first auction. Welcome back to the Block NZ Grand Finale, the night we've all been waiting for, where later on all four houses go under the hammer in our much-anticipated live auction. Now, Alex and Corbin, it's fair to say you guys push the block to territory it's never been before with your highly ambitious plan, which nearly backfired on you, didn't it?
Yeah, well, we always thought it's better to try and fail than to not try at all. And we definitely push it to the limit. But, you know, we're so happy with what we did and we wouldn't change anything.
Mm. We always knew we were going to be a bit overambitious, but we just worked as hard as we possibly could. And in the end, we did get to finish the house.
There's a little question for you. If it had been your own house that you were doing up for yourself, would you have pushed so hard?
Oh, we would have pushed even further if it was our own house, for sure. Yeah, we always kind of dream big. We're pretty ambitious people, so, yeah. I don't know about that, Mark. It's been pretty challenging, and there's been a lot of support, and we just really, really appreciate it.
Yeah. Quinn and Ben, I sense that you worried about vilifying yourselves with the population because you voted strategically in dinner wars, but then the next morning, over the fence, pops a banner with support.
Yeah, we were having a bit of a crappy time, and then we woke up one morning, came down, and the next door neighbours had flopped a banner over the fence, and it said, Quinn and Ben, you're awesome, be encouraged. And it just made us feel so good, and yeah, it was so nice, eh?
The same lady actually cooked us a fruitcake the next day as well, and I had a couple of slices and then accidentally left it out in the rain, so sorry about that.
I hope you gave her a score of more than 3 for it.
It's definitely a good 5.5.
Now, Marie and James, people have loved you, and we saw so much support at the open homes, people that were really behind you. But you guys created another fan favourite, didn't you, and Martin?
Yeah, Martin is awesome. We were so lucky to have him, and he seriously has his own following. It could probably compete against all of our followings.
The winner of the Block NZ People's Choice Competition and a brand new Honda CR-V Sport is... Joe and Damo!
Well done, buddy.
You're forgetting something, like the trophy. Oh, geez, congratulations, awesome. Damo.
So cool.
And Joe, I'll give you the keys, okay?
Oh, yay. Well, there you have it, Joe and Damo, winners of the Block NZ's People's Choice Competition and driving home in a brand new Honda CR-V Sport. Make sure you stick around because after the break, the time has come to reveal that very crucial auction order.
Coming up, the final challenge results are in and we reveal the all-important house auction order. Earlier this week, the teams took part in a triathlon of challenges, testing their creativity, their athleticism, and their knowledge of the block 2014. The winner of each challenge received 3 points. 2 points for second place, and third received 1 point. If you came last in the challenge, no points at all. Here's a reminder of just how those challenges panned out. Welcome, everyone.
Hi.
The first challenge was the Nosy Neighbours quiz, where Joe and Damo and Quinn and Ben proved they knew the most.
I feel bad.
I think in all of our opinions as well, an absolute bargain, but they do have a very positive way at looking at things. $10,000 still, guys, which means, Alex and Corbin, you are still in the running for that extra 80K. How does it make you feel after seeing that, though?
It's really sad. Oh,
yeah, so disappointed for them. I mean, yeah. They deserve so much more than that. It's really gutting.
That house is worth way more than that. Yeah. But, I mean, yeah.
Oh, but like Mark said, a lot of people are very envious of what those two have. Anyway,
yeah.
Now, Joe and Damo, they are up next, and I know that tension is most definitely building after seeing that. We will be back as their house goes up for auction.
Coming up, Joe and Damo's house goes up for sale in our live auction.
Welcome back to the Block NZ Grand Live Auction Finale, a night where we know anything can and will happen. Quinn and Ben's house has just sold with a 10K profit, leaving Alex and Corbin in the running for that additional 80K. However, there is still one more house to go under the hammer, so we will leave it over to Joe and Damo to see if they can now take the lead.
Here we go, our fourth and final auction. It's Joe and Damo, and let's face it, you guys are already winners, aren't you, tonight?
Yeah. Yeah,
got an amazing car, so thanks to all the support out there for getting us that far, so it's been an amazing night.
Yeah. Right, you've seen what's just happened. We started off gangbusters,
yeah.
Then we went very well, and then we dropped off. How does that make you feel in fourth position, having watched that?
Quite nervous.
Yeah, it is quite nerve-wracking. It's pretty scary.
I can tell because you're shaking.
I thought that was Damo.
Yeah, it's pretty shaking.
Damo, this is as close to you ever breaking as I've ever seen you, to tell you the truth.
I might even cry tonight. You never know.
I want to take you right back to that first challenge. And you won the right to select the houses, and you selected this house.
Yeah.
You still, every time I've asked you, you've said, I still back that decision. Do you still back that decision?
Yeah, we still back it.
Yes, it's just an amazing house with all its views and the privacy, and it's something we would love to own ourselves, so... We built that house around that sort of love and a homely sort of place, so and we left it at that. And so hopefully there's a buyer out there who sees the same.
I don't want this to be taken as being disparaging or disrespectful to small town New Zealand, where you guys come from, but you have put some serious big smoke swank into that joint, haven't you?
Yep. We have.
Yeah. Good old hello, Fielding. Hello, Danny Vick.
Are you ready, guys?
Yes, we're ready.
Okay, well, here we go. It's time to hand the fourth and final auction over to Sabina Davison and...
They definitely still got a bargain.
Oh.
He's all right.
Yeah. He's all right. To a TA.
Yeah.
He's a good man, and he has faith in his own work, and he should do as well.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Well, seeing awesome. You guys support each other really makes it all that much more worthwhile. But Marie and James, you have made the decision here.
Yeah.
You two are up next. Yeah. After witnessing what just happened during that first auction, how are you feeling?
Oh. The nerves are still, the heart's racing. And
It's just so crazy what just happened, and it's real. You know, this is it. This is all the work we've been, you know, everything we've been doing the last 12 weeks is all about now.
It may have felt like a sleep-deprived dream up until this point, but it's very much real, and we will be back very, very soon as the tension builds towards our second auction.
After the break, Marie and James's street side house goes under the hammer live.
Welcome back to the Block NZ Grand Live Auction Finale, where Alex and Corbin have kicked things off in exceptional fashion with a massive $227,000 profit, guys. Have you had enough time to process it?
No.
Really. Yeah. That is a lot of money to process.
Yeah. I think that profit reflects these very nice earrings that you've got here.
Maybe I could get the real one.
All right, well, we are all in good spirits here, but it's only one house down, three more to go, where Marie and James are now waiting very patiently for their house to go up for auction.
What a start by the openers, eh? Now we move into middle order. Let's see if they can build upon that, because it's Marie and James who decided the order. So first of all, why second?
We just talked to our real estate agent, and just based on the feedback we were being given on the open home, this is where they thought we should be. So we agreed, and we chose to.
So what was the motivation for making Alex and Corbin go first then?
There was no motivation, really. I think they were comfortable going first, and yeah. It was just what happened, the way we thought it would work out best for everyone, is the order we picked.
Now, you don't need to tell anyone, and please don't tell anyone, but you know what your reserve price is. Are you confident?
Yeah, it seems like a bit of a bargain, really. I mean, if someone picks it up for that, it'll be a bit of a steal.
Well, let's hope they get it for proper value then, shall we? How are you feeling?
Nervous, yeah, really nervous. It's everything we've worked for in the last 12 weeks, but at the same time excited because it sounds like there's some people who love the house.
Now let's forget how you guys are feeling. How's Martin feeling right now?
Oh, Martin's out there. He's probably feeling just as nervous, but I'm a little bit worried about my dad. He was...
$10,000, which is, well, nothing to turn your noses up at. Okay. I know you would have wanted to make more than that, especially what's happened that's gone before. How do you feel about it right now?
Look, obviously, we were hoping for a bit more than that, but the whole experience has been absolutely amazing.
Yeah.
You can't put money on that, on what we've, you know, learned and what we've been through, so...
It's all good, and 10th grand is a lot of money!
I think...
It really is.
In my eyes, you know, we're already winning in life, so...
You certainly are. I think a lot of people around the country look at you guys and are very jealous of what you two have, and you know what I'm talking about there, and what's to come as well.
Thank you, Mark.
And hopefully this will go to war. I mean, you can buy a lot of nappies for $10,000. I can promise you,
sure.
promise you that. Look, guys, you have been rookies. Do you think that you were hamstrung a little bit by the lack of challenge wins? If you had some advice for maybe the next people through about the importance of winning challenges.
I'm not really sure. If we had any more money, I'm not sure what we would have done differently. Like, the house is to an amazing standard. Like, sure, the decorating... you know, we're not amazing at that, but anyone can come in and change that. So someone's got an awesome deal there.
They certainly have.
Yeah.
And I think that's the message, Shannon. Well, these guys will walk away with $10,000. Someone's walking away with an absolute bargain, in my opinion.
I think, in all of our opinions as well, an absolute bargain, but they do have a very positive way at looking at things. $10,000 still, guys, which means, Alex and Corbin, you are still in the running for that extra 80K. How does it make you feel after seeing that, though?
It's really sad.
Oh. Yeah, so disappointed for them.
Yeah.
They deserve so much more than that. It's really gutting.
That house is worth way more than that. Yeah. But, I mean... Yeah.
Oh, but like Mark said, a lot of people are very envious of what those two have anyway.
Yeah.
Now, Joe and Damo, they are up next, and I know that tension is most definitely building after seeing that. We will be back as their house goes up for auction.
Coming up, Joe and Damo's house goes up for sale in our live auction.
Welcome back to the Block NZ Grand Live Auction Finale, a night where we know anything can and will happen. Quinn and Ben's house has just sold with a 10K profit, leaving Alex and Corbin in the running for that additional 80K. However, there is still one more house to go under the hammer, so we will leave it over to Joe and Damo to see if they can now take the lead.
Here we go, our fourth and final auction. It's Joe and Damo, and let's face it, you guys are already winners, aren't you, tonight?
Yeah.
Got an amazing car, so thanks to all that.
What are you thinking?
Awesome.
Awesome?
Really good.
Pretty good.
Really
good.
I love the front door. The front door's awesome. I want to touch it.
So you're more impressed this year than maybe last year?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think the work's just way up there. Last year was still good, but it's just like, wow.
Feedback's been sensational.
Yeah.
Like you and I, they all love the open space and feel and light brightness. They just feel that, you know, I think it's going to really appeal to a family.
Yeah, you just can't control it now. It's all out of our hands pretty much, and just got to wait and see.
You're on the Block NZ.
From the moment the dream came true.
Is this for real?
This is for real.
The ambition grew.
We're just going to bring everything. Team James Marie, high five.
Moving into Streetside House 2.
Let's go and check out this view.
We were meeting one of the Block NZ's fiercest competitors, Marie.
We've got a lot more space than our next door neighbours at the front.
But at least their neighbours were dry.
James and Marie's tarpaulin is flapping away. And buckets of water are coming down.
Whoa!
Last to get their roof on meant keeping the water out early on was an impossible task.
Seal's going on tomorrow.
And when James didn't communicate his intentions to remove the tarps, it rained tears.
Our room is flooded. Do you care so much about this house? It is quite upsetting.
Breaking point came on garage reveal day. And they finished in last place on the scoreboard.
Asking your body to just keep pushing and pushing, you've got very limited energy, and it's emotionally draining. But it's just what you gotta do. Like, we're so competitive and we're such fighters to the end.
All I know for sure, James, is we are not coming last again.
Our fire and ice couple made a dramatic comeback.
Okay.
From despair to dynamic duo in 1 week.
I really like the feel of this
room. So do I.
From last to first, Marie and James.
Oh, holy moly.
They had a secret weapon in builder Martin.
This vanity looks amazing.
He inspired James.
Well done.
Go! And the winning feeling rolled on.
We won, we won, we won, we won.
We were meeting one of the Block NZ's fiercest competitors, Marie.
We've got a lot more space than our next door neighbours at the front.
But at least their neighbours were dry.
James and Marie's tarpaulin is flapping away. And buckets of water are coming down.
Whoa!
Last to get their roof on meant keeping the water out early on was an impossible task.
Seal's going on tomorrow.
And when James didn't communicate his intentions to remove the tarps, it rained tears.
Our room is flooded. Do you care so much about this house? It is quite upsetting.
Breaking point came on garage reveal day. And they finished in last place on the scoreboard.
Asking your body to just keep pushing and pushing, you've got very limited energy, and it's emotionally draining. But it's just what you gotta do. Like, we're so competitive and we're such fighters to the end.
All I know for sure, James, is we are not coming last again.
Our fire and ice couple made a dramatic comeback.
Okay.
From despair to dynamic duo in 1 week.
I really like the feel of this room.
So do I.
From last to first, Marie and James.
Holy moly.
They had a secret weapon in builder Martin.
This vanity looks amazing.
He inspired James.
Well done.
Go! And the winning feeling rolled on.
We won, we won, we won, we won.
It's a boat.
Back in the winner's circle again, Marie and James.
They've created a modern Pacific theme with natural elements.
Gosh, this is so cool.
Pops of colour and technology at every turn.
Just tap the tuner button, straight away listen to radio.
Oh, no way! Oh my gosh!
They've wrapped a strong team around them.
What are you doing?
Oh, you're gonna love that.
And answered every demand that's been thrown at them.
Oh, it's yum. This has been an incredible journey. So many highs and then a few lows, but we've both proved to each other what it is that we can do. And I think we've both exceeded our expectations.
Are we having a baby?
No.
But one expectation hasn't been met.
I need to get a ring first, James.
Hmm?
Hmm?
I'm pretty used to getting asked when I'm gonna
Okay,
it's time to hand the fourth and final auction over to Sabina Davison, and she is going to try her hardest to sell Joe and Damo's house.
Well, very, very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And on behalf of Karen Spires and Ben Meering, I introduce you to 28A, better known as House 4 on the block. Now, it was the very first pick on the block. This, the sunniest house, of course, has been positioned and designed to create the very, very, very best of indoor and outdoor living. On entry, you're greeted immediately with a sense of welcoming space. The replacement of the wall with those gorgeous, gorgeous timber beams, well, that was described as one of the riskiest moves on the block ever. You'll agree, it really has paid off. Absolute genius, I would suggest to you. Now, first equal winners of a room reveals Joe and Damo's home, of course, is a statement. I think Joe and Damo wouldn't say effortless, but I would say effortless design style. That's luxurious, it's practical, superb use of space that we have, the calming colours to provide a home that's either a sanctuary or an entertainer's delight at will. Beautiful flow to the outdoors where there are a myriad of enjoyment options, be it an outdoor dinner party or barbecue on a warm summer eve, soak in the spa pool, a space for kids to play safely, or perfect even as a Wolverine's runabout space if you intend keeping one as a pet, as I think might have been brought up once or twice on some of the earlier episodes. Only House on the Block, of course, that offers that full second living area upstairs. Once again, that provides so much flexibility and relaxation options. Some of you buyers have even suggested it lends itself to conversion, perhaps to a fourth bedroom. So, ladies and gentlemen, buyers, what's it to be? I'm in your hands for an opening bid, opening offer. At 1 million, 1 million and 50, do I see it? 1 million opening bid. At 1 million and 50, I have now 1 million and 50, make it 1-1 where? At 1 million and 1-1. 1-1 and 150, I hear, and 1.375. That's the way to bid and buy property. Loving your work at the back there. At 1,375, do I take you to 1.4 from there? 1,375 bid. Don't let it intimidate you, folks. It underpins value here. That demand at 1,375, beautiful home. Once I call it at 1,375, do I see 1.4 where? Where's all the action? Had it all in the front row. Don't let them buy on just the one bid, folks. At 1,375, once, twice. Third time, would it make a difference if I told you I'm selling it away at 1,375,000? We're on the market. Take me along to 1.4 still, maybe even 10. Do I see at 1,375,000? Quickly now, be in. Once at 1,375,000, twice.
But you know, we're so happy with what we did, and we wouldn't change anything.
We always knew we were going to be a bit overambitious, but we just worked as hard as we possibly could, and in the end, we did get to finish the house.
There's a little question for you. If it had been your own house that you were doing up for yourself, would you have pushed so hard?
Oh, we would have pushed even further if it was our own house, for sure. Yeah, we always kind of dream big. We're pretty ambitious people, so, yeah.
I don't think that's humanly possible.
Well, we wouldn't have set ourselves 3 months to finish a house.
Now, Joe and Damo, you had a rather roller coaster ride, you could say, on the block. Damo, you were getting a little bit frustrated, weren't you, early on, because you weren't winning anything, but then all of a sudden you started to win. Second half was an absolute beauty, wasn't it?
Yeah, we sort of picked up the ball at the end and sort of ran with it, and we did really well, so really happy.
Game isn't over yet, though, is it?
Not yet, no.
No, not yet. No, it was great coming second, but when we started getting some firsts, that was an awesome feeling, so, yeah, we were very happy.
And, Joe, you just kept that smile going. You worked hard.
Yep.
Right up until the wind up my wife scenario when we saw you crack a little, didn't we?
A little bit, yeah. I just think that we were just, you know, really tired by that point, and it was a great prank, possibly not the best timing.
Bad timing. Bad prank.
I'm all good. I'm fine.
Damo, do you reckon you did any sleep building along the way?
Yeah, we did a bit of sleep building.
Building in the middle of your sleep, really, because let's face it.
Oh, yeah. No,
you were stuffed by about halfway through.
Yeah, it was mentally hard. It was physically hard, but then it got mentally hard, which was the hardest part of all. But there were some long nights there that you didn't think the 12 weeks would ever finish, but we got here and we're finally here, so it's an awesome feeling.
OK, Alex and Corbin, let's head back to your house now and the droves of fans who turned out in Point Chef. And after that, we'll have a look back at John Damo's game of two halves while on the Block NZ.
That was actually the highlight of the day for me.
So let's have a look at the Trade Me app and see how it looks on screen.
Oh, oh, it looks really great, eh?
Yeah.
Those photos are just amazing.
Have you seen how many people are watching?
Yes. No. So let's see how many views it's had. Oh, it's like 8,000.
It's had so many views already.
Do you think we've got a winner?
Oh, we think we've got a winner. Oh,
Walking in today, I felt this like immense sense of pride for what we've put together.
Okay, well, I think it's about time we handed Marie and James's Pacifica Paradise over to their auctioneer, Richard Valentine, as we see if this house will go just as well as the last house.
Good evening, I'm Richard Valentine, and I'm thrilled to offer Marie and James property at number 26, proudly marketed by Peter Tanner and Karen Clark of Bailey's. The property is aptly described Pacifica Paradise, a theme running right throughout the home, which has been constructed with flair and care and a wide appeal to discerning buyers who value smart technology, the open, bright and light living spaces flowing seamlessly to the outdoors for al fresco dining and, of course, a very safe haven for children to play. The state-of-the-art kitchen certainly is the hub of the home that interconnects with the superb gallery directly behind and also having access from the very large internal garaging for your convenience. Complemented by luxurious accommodation on the second level, the sunny master suite is reminiscent of an island retreat, complete with a walk-in wardrobe and, of course, the beautifully appointed ensuite as well, plus the bonus of a highly spec bathroom for your family or guests' pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, it's all about lifestyle, it's all about location, and it is said home is where the heart is, and this home certainly has a very, very big heart. On that note, it's yours for the bidding. Calling for opening bids to start me away. 1,275,000 will start me away. Don't let it put you off. 1,275,000 will look for 1,300,000. At 1,300,000, the bid is down here. At 1,300,000, the bid away. 1,325,000, bid's down here at the moment. 1,325,000. At 1,350,000, bid down here. 25. Sorry?
25, a quarter.
I've got 325 down here, so that will take me to 50 at 1,325,000. First call at 1,325,000. Second call at 1,350,000 I'm bid. 1,350,000 the bid now, and 1,375,000. 1,375,000 I'm bid. Round me at 1,400,000 if you will. At 1,375,000 representing 1,425,000. 1,425,000 representing excellent value here at 1,425,000. First call at 1,425,000. Second call at 1,425,000. Third, final call, all done. 450,000? 450,000 I'm bid. Straight back at 475,000 or round me at 1,500,000. $1,450,000. I hold the bid down here against the couple down here. 1,450,000. 75, or we say 1.5 on your behalf. 1,450,000. I wait for you. I'll give you a moment. No, I won't take a 5. I'll take a 10. 1,450,000. The bid's here. 1,450,000.
What?
I'm speechless. Our whole house and garage is completely flooded.
There's no way to stop water coming in without a roof.
For the first time in block history, we're going to be forced to move the room completion deadline.
What?
If we don't get Jib next week, it's on your head.
Get the guys out now!
I don't think anyone has ever been this unfinished before in the history of the block.
It just feels like big fat failure.
And this season saw some of the fiercest competition yet.
Yes! We got past them!
But they weathered the storm.
This has been an incredible journey.
I'm real proud of you.
I don't think that we will ever experience anything like this again.
And it all comes down to tonight. It's the grand finale. We'll see the thousands who swarm to the biggest Block NZ open homes in the show's history.
Welcome to the Block, everyone!
Probably one of the coolest experiences I've ever had.
The crucial auction order is decided, and the four houses go under the hammer live.
Sold here.
And we crown the champions of the Block NZ 2014.
After 12 weeks of hard labour, renovating, building, painting and plastering, I think you'd all agree, guys, this is the most important night of all, isn't it?
Yeah.
Definitely.
Joe, is that apprehension or excitement?
I'm excited. I'm a little bit nervous. Like, obviously, it's been a long 12 weeks and this is really the night that, yeah, we've all been waiting for, so it's quite scary.
Damo, we never really see much out of you.
No.
Will the poker face be broken if you happen to win this thing?
Oh, yeah, I'd be chucking a few beers down my throat, eh? Yeah.
Marie and James, you've been wonderful to follow along, haven't you? James, how did you control her? Because this is me that charging out of the water and completing the puzzle was Marie and James, because Marie, the minute the gun went off and you entered that water, it was all on, wasn't it?
It was just so cold. I just wanted to make sure it was in and out as quick as possible.
And James, how about that blood-curdling scream when she finished it?
Oh, tell me about it. I think she gave everyone a fright, including herself.
Yeah.
OK, but right up the top there, on 4 points, is Quinn and Ben. Now, you guys are yet to win a challenge. This would be a big one to win, wouldn't it?
Yeah, definitely. It would be something a bit different if we won something on the block this year, wouldn't it?
Why not leave it to the last night?
Yeah.
We've got no idea what order we'd want to go in, but if anyone's going to choose, it would be cool if it would be us.
Well, I'll tell you who can't choose. Alex and Corbin, who won everything along the way, but because of your very poor performance in these first two challenges, you have no chance here, do you? Does that concern you in any way?
No, it doesn't really concern us. The auction's going to be a bit of a lottery, so, yeah.
We feel we've done all we can do now, and it's up to the buyers.
Right. The final viral video challenge was left up to you, the viewer, to decide. Shannon, you want to do the honours for us?
Well, we have tallied those final scores. The winner of the Auction Order Decider Challenge and the team that gets first dibs on Auction Order here tonight is Marie and James.
Madden!
Who would have thought a topless Scotsman in a kilt could have done such a good job?
The ladies love Martin.
So that's great news. I've got some even better news for you right now. I want that auction order now.
Oh, goodness.
No pressure.
Oh, my gosh. Now?
Look, I know it's a big decision, guys, and I don't want to rush you. But I am going to rush you because we haven't got all night. So what's it going to be?
Yeah, it's pretty huge. We've had to talk to the Bailey's guys and the open homes and things like that. And yeah, we think we want to go second. Put Alex and Corbin first.
Okay.
And then Quinn and Ben in third, and then Joe and Damo in fourth.
Yeah, we just wanted to do what we felt was best for everyone, and based on the advice we were given, we feel that's the right thing to do.
We're all happy with that?
Yep.
Good.
Start breathing again.
Well done. That was tense, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It's just we're holding everyone's futures in our hands. That's how we feel right now.
Well, you should feel that way. And just like that,